Hello and welcome to the show.
Hi.
How's everybody doing tonight? And also, why is my audio not working? I'm absolutely miffed as to how this could have broken. Fixed it. Hey, everybody. Look, it's me, Tommy D. How you guys doing?
I think it's time for...
Yeah, bringer of bingus.
It's like one of the seven plights. Is a little bit of bingus. A little bit of bingus from the big dingus.
Beautiful vibes tonight? What is this beautiful song?
Little Monkey Island 3? Bingo tonight, you better believe it. I hope y'all... Ironheart! Ironheart, thank you for the 27 months of support. I got a big kazoo for me to you. And also, TJ Lines, thank you for gifting a sub to Doozy. I caught that even before it came up. Genius. I'm amazing.
Thank you kindly. What the heck?
I hope you all enjoyed the horrifying clip I posted today. That one was... I was rooting around for a good one from the last cast, and I couldn't choose between the mashed potato bread deep fried mess or the panties that have... a thing that you push up against your vagina so that you can pee through it, and then it goes out of a tube and out your car window. But you know what? I went for the less gross of the two. Arguably. There were a lot of good clips last time we streamed, bingo. Yeah, panty catheter. Yeah, it's fun. You don't gotta put it in the urethra. It's just like a, it's like what would that be called? I guess there's no real godly name for it, right?
Don't worry about it. It's okay.
It's okay. Firebolt, thank you for retweeting my clip about the show tonight. Which reminds me, I do have to actually hop on that and say that I am casting. Ninja Steez, hello! Howdy fucking hey. And as always, we're starting with Chef's Club Bingo. I know you're thinking that we're not, but we are. Here we go. Let me do this. And let me throw a little... Gaga! So I'm just screaming. Goggle. Fucking howdy, hey, what up today? Good to have you, buddy. How's it going? Thank you for the 77 months of support, you lovely sot.
After working at 3 a.m. all this week, I have to say it.
Mm.
Canada is still a fake
Fuck!
Country, and
hey!
No matter how many times you tell, it's still a lie.
No!
It's very real. It's my nationality. You are a bigot.
Yay! Also, Mariture! Fuck train, baby. Everybody's on the fuck train. It's like a conga line of penetration. Thank you for the 60 months. I have another kazoo, but this one's for you. Are you enjoying the village? Oh, you better believe it. I finished it. I finished it just yesterday, and it comes with a heavy recommendation. It is a good game. It is a good time. Keith! Keith, thank you so much for the big 20. How you fucking doing? I got kazoo for me to you. Mouse, I am so glad you brought it up. I'm so glad you bought yourself some some Milkies. Because guess what? I've got me some Milkies too. Guess what I've got more of though? Some soju. It's very green. Look at that. Oh, so what am I holding? Who knows? Who can tell? This, I'm going to bash the mic as many times as possible. This is Chum Chum Yogurt Soju. And it's probably overkill putting Milkies in it, but I'm doing it. I'm going to mix the two of these live on cast, and I'm going to die. I'm going to get, like, some sort of weird heart palpitation from drinking this. I'm worried, and I'm scared. Dango, what up? What'd I miss the past week? All of Resident Evil. But now you're spoiler free. What is Milkies? Oh, yeah, for those who don't know, Milkies is a refreshing milk and yogurt soda. So think about that for a minute.
No.
Think about that. I can say it twice if you want. Anyways, I'm going to now put my yogurt beer in here.
I made an app for the stream for a bit of practice and tweeted it to your lad.
Did you really? Wait a hot tit. I want to see that. Let's take a breather from the intro for just a second. Holy shit, you did. Let me, bingo card. Look at this. I made an app because remembering the emote names is hard. No fucking way.
Did you think Lady Dimitri rescued today? I hope you did.
I as soon as I woke up and as soon as I went to bed. Wow. Interesting main string. Pattern string. What is this? Chrome emote string. And there's all the fucking emotes. How fucking cool. Insanity Live Emote Hub version 4.20.69. Okay. Sure. Pretty good. I do like that. That's fucking cool as hell. What the hell? I'm just gonna yell. Holy shit, this is rad. Damn. Fucking cool. I hope it helps you with your emotes and stuff. Fucking hell. I do. Oh, Gov. Gov, thank you for the 100 bits.
Nice.
I think it's time we put some soju into this thing. DMCA! Tom, wait. DMCA the app? You can't use my likeness. You're going to hell. This is just liquid. This is this looks like water. It smells like alcohol. I'm going to take a sip. Let's take a pre-Milkies sip. There it is. Okay, you ready? Please don't drink it like water. We're going to get trashed tonight. Okay, here we go. Kinda nice.
Hype train time.
There it is. Thank you. Thank you for propelling that hype train. It's hard to describe. It really is. It does kind of have like a yogurty taste, but that's all I got.
Is milk yeast like kefir?
No. Kefir is like really thick. Milk yeast is actually like carbonated milk. And it's real. I know it sounds so gross. It's delicious. But you guys are going to hate it when I pour it into here, because as soon as I pour it into here, you're going to see it get like cloudy and gross. So get ready. Here we go.
Thick water, but it is milk.
Oh, yeah. Okay. There we go. And now it's come. We've come full circle.
Now make a milkshake out of it.
I mean,
bring all the boys to the yard and crack a cold one with the boys.
Oh, I regret everything. Okay, you ready? Hey! I thought you'd want me to do this! Joker! It's not gross. It's a beautiful, milky beverage. So milky and good. I do have a kazoo for me to you. Yeah, it's thick water. For real men who like to chew their water.
Coming in my milky drink.
Okay. Happy Mother's Day, everybody. That almost changed nothing.
Oh, you! Shut your mouth and look at my wad!
Okay.
Come, baby.
Fuck you. Let me see. What was the proof? 12% alcohol for 360 milliliters, which this is, I think.
Mean idea. We get to select some alerts with them since the economy is born.
We get to select some alerts with them. Oh, God. I wonder if I could even set that up. I might have to do some custom coding for that. I have no idea.
Oh, you! Shut your mouth and look at my wad!
Look at that big old mug of cold. Then come.
Thin goom. Just nasty. Hi, Mox. Welcome.
It's cum water. Oh, okay.
Come on, guys. I didn't come to this cat. To be bullied like this. Fucking Christ. Goomer water. Fuck, y'all are nasty. This is a safe space. It's a safe space to bully Tom.
Me when I find Lady Dimitrescu's bath water.
I don't. Is it gonna be weird like this? Why is the bath water like cloudy?
You brought this on yourself.
Uh-oh. This was a requested beverage. Klaus wanted me to drink this, and I wanted to try it because it sounded really good. Some dude. Oh, I was in Mexico. Some dude sold us peyote. Did you take it? Did you get? I don't even know what it would be. It's not even high, right? Did you go crazy on peyote?
Isn't that like nature's coke?
No, that's, is it a hallucinogen? I just know it's a little cactus. I have no idea. DMT? That would mess me up. I don't know if I could do something like that. I didn't take it. My cousin wanted to take it. Oh! Hard to say no to peyote. I would be scared of a stranger giving me something and being like, yeah, just put this in you. Take this, put this in you, you'll have a great time. I don't know why, but I'm like, I gotta go to the source. I gotta go get this in a healthy way. I don't know where you can healthily get peyote, but I don't even know if it's illegal. Hi, source. How you doing? Tom and his cool. He's had a good cum day. Great cum day. He was like, hey, you want peyote? Just don't eat it. It gotta put it in tea. But you can eat it. Oh, okay. I love the rules. Have you been drinking the cum water again? It gets messy. Gary's taken. Welcome, buddy. We're starting the cast off. Just balls the wall nonsense. Maddie Dordis! Thank you so much for following the channel. I hope I almost said your name correctly. What are you drinking? I'm drinking Guinness. This is soju and milkies. I got the soju, and I got the milkies. Milkies and soju. Milkies.
Gum water for pussy chicken.
A scarier sentence has never been said to me in my life. Garuda, hello! How you fucking doing? What's up? The Korean combo. I heard it was good, and it is. It is actually quite good. Hey, Daisy! I guess we're gonna have to start the cast, aren't we? I guess we're going to have to start the show. Are you guys ready? Lifehack bingies when? Probably never. We have a bunch of beautiful videos lined up by the illustrious Chefy Club. I think, how many do we have here? We've got four. I think there's always been four. Finally got vaccinated today after figuring out my previous appointment was a system error. Ooh, that's yuck, but
hell yes.
Not the cheese. Are you kidding me? Of course we're going to do the cheese. The cheese is a necessity. What do we, is there actually one that's cheese? Yeah, Cheese Mania. They're just going to take huge box of cheese and be like, you know what you should do? Eat cheese. And that's it. I'm eating. Don't do this to me. You knew what you were getting into as soon as you saw the cum. All right, let's do this. For those of you at home that don't have it, type exclamation mark Chef Bingo to get your own beautiful Chef Bingo card. And we will start by marking off the first square and drinking more booze. Okay. Let's do this. TikTok trends, three recipes to try at home. This is going to be bad. What the fuck is this song? What is this song that I'm listening to? Rome. It's beautiful. Okay, you know what? Let's keep it going. And also, let's mute this. Are those meat roses? He's making meat roses. Oh, that looks just disgusting. Oh, it's just like Resident Evil 8. I feel like if you did this with vegetables or fruit, people would be like, haha, that's fun, even though I would still hate it. But using meat really does fucking ruin it, I feel. Jesus. Oh, that's so much meat. Oh, no. 15 crepes, you know, as you do. 15 crepes! Okay, cover it with ham. Slice Swiss cheese. How is this a TikTok trend? Is this a meat and crepe lasagna? What? I would burst that glass and there would be glass in my hand, for sure. Why wouldn't you just take a circle cutter? Okay. Holy shit, this would take an eternity. And there's holes in it. Cause you get... I still got so many crepes to use. Holy shit.
On this episode of Chef Club, we make a meat fleshlight.
Just horrid. You're not far off. It is looking fairly horrid.
Shitty ratatouille.
Is that what ratatouille is? I thought ratatouille was usually veg or something. Is this like carnivore and carbivore ratatouille? Hell yeah, bake it. Why? They're already made crepes. I guess just to melt the cheese. Oh, there's where the holes are. Oh, it's like a dice. It's a five. You rolled a five. Bake it again. Nice. Are you going to take the meat flowers and put them in the holes? Oh, I don't like meat. No. I don't know why I look at that and I think of prolapse, but... Okay, there they are. They're going in. Some of them aren't fitting. Lettuce! That's not lettuce. Okay. What do you guys think about this one? Hey, what do you guys think about... I mean, we're going to see the cross-section in a second, but... What do you think of the prolapse cake? Honestly, I'd eat this. I wouldn't. I actually wouldn't. Do you think we should just call it... I don't know. One of the most contentious squares on the bingo card is whether or not you would eat a fucking frozen pizza. I personally would rather eat a frozen pizza than the meaty mess that I saw before. Not the crepe body. No, it's too much work. I'd just eat the roses. Like, how do you consume it? Do you take a slice? I'm excited to see the cross-section. Prep time too long, carb nightmare. Oh, it's 100% a carb nightmare. It's a meat nightmare. There's like 12 different cold cuts. I don't know. I think it's dangerous because they literally say use a champagne glass as a cutter. If that champagne glass snaps, you're getting glass in your hand. And I could see that happening with a cheap champagne glass. Fetish. It looks gross. Come on! I dare you to argue me that! Comical plating. They surrounded it in, like, spinach. I mean, lettuce. Overcooked, undercooked? They did bake it twice for 20 minutes. Twice. And I don't know what that would do other than just melt some fucking cheese and overcook everything else.
I would rather drink the blood wine from Re8.
I'd drink the blood wine. I honestly, if you offered me the ability to drink the blood wine from Resident Evil 8, just to impress Lady D, I'd do it. I'd do it in a heartbeat. Oh yeah, prep time way too long. Abso-fucking-lutely. Do you think... Huge portion. Yeah, this thing's monstrous. It's 15 crepes! The average human in a month probably eats two. I can't imagine somebody eating 15 in one sitting. Tastes gross. Do you think this would taste gross? I mean, it's just meat and crepe and a little bit of cheese. Unidentifiable meat. Yeah, you know what? I don't think they described at least one of them. I'll just call it there. What's the square behind your cum glass? Oh yeah, sorry, the cum glass is in the way. My cum jar, excessive chocolate and makes Tom speechless. I don't know if we got to that point, but maybe we were. Jump drive, hello, howdy hoopty. Also, Adam, thank you for retweeting my clip about the stream tonight. I didn't actually say that I was streaming yet, which I will do as soon as we go back to the show. Oh yeah, we didn't do a prediction. Oh shit, that's on me. I should have started a prediction. Let's do a prediction right now. Let's do a prediction. We're one menu in. Let's do it. I don't give a shit. I don't care if you guys can tell. I don't care if there's a little bit of... This is... I did it wrong. You know? It's fine. Did I spell prediction wrong? Predic-ition. Yeah, I got an extra I in there. Start prediction. I'm gonna do it. Because Chef's Club is a little bit weird. I'm gonna do greater than two, less than two. Do you think with what we have now, and I will show you, just so you know that it's not rigged, everybody has the same advantage slash disadvantage here. Do you think there's enough here to get us two bingos? I mean, you're looking at the same card, aren't you? I mean, I say vote now. Vote with your beans. Imagine the upset. Oh my god, nobody's putting beans on it being not two bingos. And I believe that. I think the odds are in the favor of the more bingos. I think there's a very good chance we will get three bingos on this, but I don't want to sway anybody. Vote with your heart and not with your ears, as in listening to what I say, because I'm a fucking moron, and I don't want you to yell at me if I mess up and everybody gets sad. But I think we're done. I think we're done with the card. There might be some more arguments as to other things we can add, but for now, I say we continue and we watch this fucking cross section. Oh. Ew. Imagine the texture of biting into that. That's horrid. Oh. Oh my good god. Do it. Do a cut. Do a slice. Now you're taking a part of the rose. There it is. I mean, it's not inedible. I feel like I could bite into this and still kind of enjoy it, but like, I'd never pursue it. I'd never be like, God, I gotta get that 5 Michelin star. I think it only goes up to 3. 5 Michelin star crepe disaster. Oh man, horrid. And apparently, that's a TikTok trend. Anyone that uses TikTok, can you vouch for this? Can you vouch for the crepe disaster? Your crepes would be overcooked and rubbery? They would be. They'd be so unflavorful. I'm gonna go back to the card, and I am gonna mark off over slash undercooked. I'm not gonna mark off taste gross. I think this would taste good, but it would be unpleasant to eat. Whoa, the egg swizzle. Everyone's favorite TikTok trend. I mean, I just like, who cares? Red enchilada sauce? That's a lot of sauce! Corn tortillas, you know, just 50. 50 corn tortillas. Uh-huh. Are you making tortilla fries? You're gonna fry them. Yeah, you are. Oh, no. So they're like little tortilla crisps. Sure. You are making so many of these fucking things. Oh. Tom is making up TikTok trends. I'm not. The egg one, the egg spinner. That's one I've seen before, I feel. Oh, they're gonna get soggy and shitty. Why even fry them if you're gonna just... Okay. How is this a TikTok trend? Oh, ew. Have you ever wanted soggy tortillas? Oh, yuck. Oh, my God. Oh, why did you do that? Okay, here we go. I don't know why you even put the oil in there. You really didn't need it. Can't get that. I can't get that Shrek vomit. Uh-huh. The texture itself is a nightmare. I can't imagine biting into anything she's produced in the last, like, minute. Oh, God. Are you kidding me? Oh, that looks awful. Okay, three eggs. There's no way she can save this. There's no way she's saving this. Because I know she's just going to make a little tornado. Here we go. Egg tornado. Uh-huh. Wow, she's so careful. There it is. Just like the TikTok says to how to do egg tornado. It's not really holding well. Yeah, that was... I mean, this looks... I mean... It's just egg. Oh, yuck. Oh, it's not even centered. Oh, you're basting it in hot sauce? What is Kojita? I don't know what cheese that is. Radishes. Sure, fuck it. Why not? Okay, and everybody's favorite garnish, cilantro. Oh. Oh, it's like an eldritch horror. Oh my God. How do you eat this? What do you do? You can't consume this and not vomit. Look at how sweaty this shit is down here. This is the worst.
It's a really shitty sombrero.
It is. I hate this. Also, holy fuck, T-Lex. Thank you for the big raid. Don't mind me while I sip this big glass of cum. Welcome, everybody. I hope that you can withstand me. We're doing Chef's Club Bingo. It's a show where we look at horrible things, and then we mark it off on this card. And then I drink a lot. Oh. It's a good time. Sometimes I lose my mind. It's worth it. Shut up. Anyways. And a go punch. And Alex, thank you for the follows. Welcome, good to have you. How does it? How does this look like Christmas vacay turkey? It's like a turkey disaster. Oh, you know what? Just for everybody catching up, here's what we just witnessed. I'm doing the ad lib version of it. You ready?
Yes.
Somebody took like 40 tortillas and chopped them into thin strands. Jump drive. What the fuck? Thank you for the big 1K with the bits and the whatnot. And Ninja, thank you for gifting us up to T-Lex.
The potential texture alone makes me want to vomit.
It'd be so wet. I'm not letting that go. I'm going to go right back to that. Ninja, thank you for gifting us up to T-Lex. Lex!
Oi, you! Shut your mouth and look at my wad!
Fine!
Would you rather eat this or drink a mug of cum?
I don't like that I had to think about that. I'd probably eat this. I don't know if I'm into the cum. Anyways, Lex, I hope you enjoy all the fucking horrible emotes. And I hope you can stick around for at least a little bit. I know it's stupid o'clock. What is it? Bedtime time? Probably. Anywho, she takes these tortillas. She chops them into strands. She takes all of them, deep fries them. Oh, look at those. Crispy, delicious. They're like fries. How cool is that? Throw some salt on them, season some more, and then drown them in enchilada sauce. Fucking get them nice and soggy in enchilada sauce. Yeah, that was my reaction too. I was like, I know, I've done that all the time. Fuck, Uncanny Andy, thank you so much for the 7 months. I got Kazoo.
from me to you.
Also, Emrose, thank you for the prime. I hope you enjoy your night, and I hope you also enjoy all my horrible emotes. Anyway, you get some soggy.
Oh, God. It just, it looks like
somebody stomped on a can of Chef Boyardee. And then you take some time to crush up some chicken and fry it with some sauce. I don't remember. What was it?
Salsa verde.
You just mix that shit all together and you make this awesome fucking Shrek boogie soup. And then you pound it into a cup and bing bada boom. Ugh. And you got that. Then you mix up some eggs and then you make a little egg tornado with your choppy sticks. Just like those TikTok kids that love to tick the talk. And then you throw it on top of it, cover the whole thing in hot sauce, baste it. And I don't know, fuck it, here's some cheese. And then after the cheese, I don't know, fuck it, radishes. And that's it. There it is. Oh yeah, and cilantro. Sorry, the herb everybody loves ubiquitously. That's the meal. That's the meal. That's the quickie recap. I dare you to fucking eat this. I will say, and I'm gonna go back to the cross section because I like to have a visual. This whole mess down here is so damp and so gray. That it's like a whole new texture. Look, tasty frog. No, please. I loved you. I think that this would taste really fucking gross. Which is a bingo. And we take a shot. And by shot, I guess I mean a chug. Just a little one. I don't know what else we could even mark off. Maybe, like, unusual ingredients. There's a lot of stuff that I just don't have. Frozen pizza, please. Yeah, I think we can safely say most people in chat would rather have a frozen pizza than fucking this. Than whatever this is. It's just horrid. I couldn't imagine any part of that meal touching my tongue and not gagging. Speaking of, I did gag in the first viewing. Is there anything else we could throw on? What about actually good? Were you guys thinking about that one? Do you like Guinness? I love Guinness. I'd eat a Pizza Hot Pocket instead of that. That's fair. I mean, if I could choose Pizza Hot, I think that Pizza Hot Pocket's even more versatile than a regular pizza. Chat Angie, is chat mad? I thought chat was just very dismayed. Are you guys having a angry time? Upsetty that this wasn't spaghetti? I mean, it would have been just much better if it was spaghetti. I'm not mad. I am seeing some grumpy faces, though. There's some grump. I'll take it. Where's chat mad? And I think they didn't use ranch. They did not use ranch. I think we're good. Let's do it. Let's do some more. Nitro cold brew Guinness. Fuck, where the fuck do you get that? That sounds awesome. Oh, God. They cut too soon. Look at her face. They cut so soon. They're like, let's not let her mull over the taste. There was, like, I think that flash right there. You see it? Okay, so wait. She's taking in the taste. I'm going screenshot by frame by frame on this. That right there. That's her soul leaving her body. And now she's a husk. That's all it was. Was just like a flash of pain. Just like, ah! And then she was back to normal. And then they cut. Probably before she spat it out. Oh. Trust me, please eat this. Please, it's our career to make these videos. I need you to eat this. Okay, here we go. Last recipe, probably. The fuck are you doing? Okay. It's gonna require chopsticks, whatever it is. Eggy yolkies. Yeah, cut that shit. There. What the fuck? This is so precise. Pipette with water? So you've got why would you ever steam yolks this way? I would honestly say buy like a steamer basket, but like, I mean, they're like a dollar. Okay, potato shavings in cold water. This is always gross, but you know what? It's fair. You do this and then you squish them. I've done this before. I hate doing it, but you can do it. It's the best way to get mash. Oh, he's using this as a little sieve. That's smart, actually. I like that. They're probably still a little wet.
Ah, gross.
Is this funky hash browns? Is that what- I mean, this is a video of TikTok trends. So anyone that actually uses TikTok kind of has the upper hand here as to what's going on. Probably. I'd like to hope. I'd like to hope there's some method to this madness. Is he just going to take the steamed yolks and put them on the hash browns and then that's it? He's got the egg whites from the yolks.
I use TikTok and there is nothing like this.
Yeah, I had a feeling. I had a sneaking suspicion. That's a horrible way to flip a thing. But you know what? Cool, you got three of them. Is he making like a little eggy burrito? Those are some crisp browns. Oh, is he gonna make... Oh, he's making a matzo crisp. I like it. I should have had bacon on the card instead of ranch. Oh, wait, no, bacon's on the card. Never mind. Keep an eye out. I don't know why they went tiny on us. And now they're back to big. Why? Ew. What?
TikTok goes the clock. Eat these and your clock will stop.
Basically, this is an instant heart attack. It's hash browns and then an egg in the middle and then cheese wrap with bacon and then egg white wrapped and then fried again. Well, that one's different. The hash brown's kind of inside. Phew, goes the plane. Uh-huh. I don't want to subscribe. Parsley? Nice. Maple syrup?
Sauce.
I feel like this is too much effort for something that is basically a breakfast meal you could get at a truck stop diner. I think you could go to a truck stop and get a much better meal than whatever this is. And I hate the idea of a steamed yolk. Wouldn't you want the yolk to be runny? Like, I know some people don't like it, and I, for one, used to fucking hate runny yolks until I discovered the magic that is Eggs Benedict. So, this is the worst omelet. It's like non-runny, it's a cooked yolk, so I don't know why they steamed it. What's the point of steaming a yolk? Like, you might as well just, like, I don't know. What's it called when you just throw it in water? I already forgot. Shit, I do this all the time. Poached egg, there you go. You just poach the fucking egg. Poach the egg for too long so that the yolk hardens. You can just do that. I don't know why you gotta, like, separate it and then put it on a chopstick and then steam it. That's a whole thing, dude. That's a whole thing. Anyways. Hey, I spied some bacon, and that's bingo number two. I'm gonna tell you right now, this huge stein full of cum is really messing me up. Like, I did not expect soju to hit as hard as it does, but it is, it's tickling the ivories of my nerve endings, and I think I'm losing sensation a lot quicker than I would be if I was drinking just straight whiskey.
For all that effort they put into it, they could go to a hole-in-the-wall Mexican restaurant and have really good breakfast taco.
Quite literally. It'd be so easy. Is that soju? You're boned. I know. And technically, I have another soju and milkies sitting in the fridge. This was just the yogurt edition. I was gonna go get the strawberry one because it sounded pretty good. I think that, yeah, I was speechless. Which is another bingo. I feel like I was kind of speechless because I was, like, confused. Especially with the yolk ceremony at the beginning. Which is another bingo. Let's take another. Fantastic. And, I don't know if there's anything else to really mark off. Unusual ingredients, too much butter, actually good. I think that's it. Bad editing. Was there bad editing? They usually have bad editing. I always forget which Commodore 64 game this is. This is Keen, isn't it? Was Commander Keen on Commodore 64? Nah, I forget. It may actually be good. I feel like this thing, I'm not gonna fuck around. I think that this thing could taste really good. I think it would taste better if the yolk was runny, and I think it's way too much work for how little is actually in it. I don't know if I could say actually good, we might be able to mark it off. If chat's general consensus is actually good, I'll do it. Because I think this would taste good. I think this would taste good, but you would never you'd never want to get it. I'd eat it. You know what? Sure. Let's do it. Maybe we should mark off actually good is better than a frozen pizza. Let's do it. That's another bingo. Yeah, the maple. I don't know about the maple syrup. Salsa's probably okay. But everything else, no. Runny yolk, though, I agree. I think it would add so much. And there we go. That's the first Chef's Club bingo. I think what we need to do now is, one, complete that prediction. I'm so sorry to everyone that voted number one. It was, in fact, greater than two. I think we had, like, three or four or something. Whichever. And flip a coin. No. Let's also... I gotta go to Twitter. I'm sorry. I forgot to yell at everybody. It's life hack bingo time. Oh, wait. Can I close this? Can I quote retweet myself? Is that a fucking thing on this stupid It is! Life hack bingo... Ah! I can't even... Sorry! Life hack bingo time. Get your rears in here! Zzz. There, perfect. Sorry, I love rhymes and I'm drunk. Perfect. Amazing. What? Oh, wait, I didn't put a link. Fuck! Can I quote retweet my quote retweet of a quote retweet? And then with the quote retweet, I actually give a link to the fucking channel? Quote retweet. Oh, also, here's a link. I'm bad at this. There we go. Hashtag life hack bingo. Everybody's gonna unfollow me because I'm spamming their feeds. https://twitch.tv/unsanitylive. Can I type it right? I did! I'm gonna take the HTTPS out of there. I think we're good. Oh, also here's a link. Fuck, I'm bad at this. Good enough. Tweet it. Fuck it. Get it out of there. Let's do a quote retweet of that retweet. Jesus, I'm stupid. Well, either or.
Oh my
goodness, no. I mean, Pterodactyl, thank you so much for resubbing with Church Sunday. Who gifted you the sub? Oh my god, my feed is just a constant stream of people liking and retweeting each individual quote retweet. Thanks for support, y'all. I love it. Also, I'm stupid. Miss Tennessee! Shut. That's a great username. Fuck. Thank you for following the channel. I hope you're enjoying the show. And here's a kazoo from me to you, Pterodactyl. I forgot I did that almost a year ago. I can't fucking believe that. There's gonna be an anniversary for the gift sub you gave, Church Sunday. Is that not wild? Jesus Christ. Okay. Oh. Hey! Oh. Okay, no!
Oh, you did it!
Oh, I love the streams, love talk. You shut. Fuck you. Thank you. That's really sweet. Thank you for the 4 months as well. I have a kazoo from me to you. Okay. I just like Zelda too. Well, I like the music to Zelda too. Anyways, Friday King, thank you for the follow, and hey! Enough about me. Let's get to the next video. For those who don't know, you can actually... type exclamation mark chef's bingo. Chef bingo, not plural. And you get your own bingo card. If you're already sitting on this bingo card screen and your bingo card's like mostly fold out, you know what? Unfold that card. It's time to receive a new card. You click here, you retabulate, you recalculate, and bing bada boom. All your squares are in different positions. It's like a whole new game. Wow, amazing. The future's here. That showed you really hit you fast. Yeah. Did you have any food prior? I had a huge plate of pasta. I made myself spicy Italian sausage with bow tie noodles in bolognese and with fresh Parmesan. It was amazing. Amazing pasta dish. And it was a huge fucking bowl. It was like a whole pot of pasta. And I'm like... Didn't do a thing to stop me from not getting drunk. Didn't do a fucking thing. I'm already just a mess. So I can't imagine how much worse this is going to get. How
bad is it compared to whiskey?
40% alcohol per volume, and this soju is 12%. I think... I remember this being a problem with my early streams. The first time I ever drank on Cast, I had... What was that energy drink? There was an energy drink that was also booze. And I had that, and it fucking destroyed me. I can't remember what it was called. Four Loko. Yeah, I had Four Loko. Because in my mind, I was like, oh, I'm a little baby bitch, and I don't know if I like drinking yet, because I was 18, which was legal, and is still legal where I am. And it really messed me up, because I think my body deals with sugar differently. I think if I have, anytime I have alcohol and there's sugar, it destroys me in seconds. Whereas if I'm having pure whiskey, I'm an adult for at least a couple of hours. But, you know, give me some sugar drink. Get me some fucking wine, or get me some goddamn fruity drinks, and I'm done, dude. I'm done in. I was gonna take another sip. I think you're drinking too fast. That's true. It was at like half volume, and now it's not as much. Either or, sugar equals hangover. Yeah, and I have to do a co-cast with a bunch of other streamers tomorrow, so. Oh no. I'll be fine. I'll just be awful. Thank you guys for all the retweets. Oh! Am I right? I don't even know what I said. Lazalu, thank you so much for the 6 months. I've got a bit of a kazoo for a bit of you. Sugar and alcohol are processed by the same system in your body, so sugary drinks make you drunk faster. I thought that was just a Tom quirk, not an everybody quirk.
Local Canadian man gets drunk off of cum.
Yeah. It's not you, that's just Four Loko. Caffeine and alcohol is a terrible idea. I wonder how much caffeine is in a Milky's, because they really... I mean, it's not supposed to be something that has, like, caffeine. It's just cane sugar and milk, which is just... Maybe alcohol and milk is a bad idea, too. Fuck my entire body. Anyways, why do I need an account to lurk? Thank you for following me on Twitter. It's a good account name. Okay, I'm ready now. Are you ready? Let's do Chocomania, huh? Let's go see. Oh, he's slurping the Choco. Okay, you ready? Hi, Tom. Let's do a little prediction. This one will be an honest prediction, one that we won't have the cheating of knowing what's going on. I am still going to keep it to two, because sometimes we don't even get two. I think I remember the last week I did this. I was like, I got to lower the limit. I got to lower the limit, the amount of bingos that you can get. Is Canadian cum sold in bags? Fuck me.
Is Canadian cum sold in bags?
I read that, and I regretted reading that. Fuck. Which video is this, and what's your bingo card look like? Ooh, good question. Also, if you'd like a bingo card of your own, again, type !! bingo in the chat. But here's mine. We've got a little bit of a layout here. I'm going to move the cum. Makes Tom gag worse than a frozen pizza, makes chat mad, unsanitary live, there's a bunch of stuff. Unsanitary live literally just means if it's unsanitary. And not the way that you would produce it if there's anything in the video where it's like, oh, this is actually unsanitary, you're disgusting. Like one time they took an IKEA lamp and wrapped a turkey around it and then baked the entire thing. They are absolutely mad. So, keep an eye out for shit like that. Lots of stuff. Who's the co-cast with? I don't know if it's a secret. It's probably better if it's not, because then you guys can all... Hey! Hold him. Thank you so much for the 28. I got a kazoo from me to you. Where's my phone? An IKEA lamp. Yes, it was.
There is already bagged cum. It is called a condom.
Oh, yeah. Fair point! Who's it with? If I'm not mistaken, it's going to be... No, not Shrek. It's on Bloody Faster's channel. And there are also other streamers there, too. And they might also be streaming. And if I'm not mistaken, this is going to be part of a little bit of a charity stream. Maybe even for St. Jude. I don't know. Maybe y'all should stop on in tomorrow!
at Bloody Fascist Channel. I will not be streaming it, sadly, but I resubbed 2 days ago. Whoopsies. Anyways, go fucking go. Yeah, can we get a shout-out command for Bloody Faster? And by can we, I mean, why don't I fucking type it?
Bloody Faster.
I typed it, but to the wrong computer. Can we do this again? Shout-out.
Bloody Faster.
There you go. So, I'll be, oh, my beverage splashed. I'll be hanging out, playing games with, Bloody and folks tomorrow evening. St. Jude, are they gonna send you another chair? That was entirely Harley. Harley got this chair and was like, Tom can have it. He was the actor in the Shrek thing, and also, he's kinda cool. And she sent me a chair, it was really nice. Anywho, stop on by tomorrow. Go follow Bloody Faster. I'll message the Discord, and I will retweet whatever tweet she has for announcing the cast, and we'll pop in. We'll pop in, we'll say hi, we'll play a game, and hopefully everybody in chat roots for me, because I'm going to win a lot. I'm going to get so many points. I'm going to get so many cool things. Will you host it? I absolutely will. Anyways, sorry. Back to the life hack. Hey, our prediction is set, and so am I. Let's go. I think he's just going to make a little choco tube or choco dollops. You can literally buy these. I don't know why you would have to melt chocolate and make your own. Okay. Oh, that's why. So you can give them tails. Uh-oh. Also, hi, Fubu. Choco sperm. Choco gummies. Okay. Oh, no. And then, oh, ew. Those are with his fingers. Oh, he's fingying. Why would you fingy it? Oh, yucky. Chalky fing. I don't like it. Yeah, I think that one's a little unsanitary. He's not wearing gloves or anything. He's just like getting in there and going. Heavy whipping cream. Just boil the shit out of it. Nice. You're getting the two different chocos? Melting those bad boys. Oh, I love to see it. And then chilling it. Are you whipping the chocolate? Okay. Nice. That one didn't even need to be whipped, really. It was just thick as shit. Huh. Okay. Interesting. I feel like this isn't going to be like a tiramisu, but it's going to be like a layered chocolate thing, right? That was a binder protector page? Was it really? No, that's for cooking. That, you guys don't know how binder protectors work. They're great for cooking. Very okay. Oh, this is so much work. I don't know what it is. If it's more than a cake, I give up. It's been a while since I've baked anything other than a cake or brownies or cookies, but this is just, it's like chocolate goop, tiered chocolate goop. All right, here we are. Filling it. Just filling it. Oh, nice, nice. Freezing it. Oh, he's gonna spill those. Oh, no, he's good. Look at him. So it's a brick of chocolate. Also, if you can tell me what song this game is from. Song this, yeah. I dare you to. I don't know, I'll give you a big kiss. That's why I realized I formatted that sentence as if it was a thing. There we are. Ooh, look at that. The Beanness game. Tomb Raider, no. I bet it's a game most people have played. I bet it's a lot of a game people have played, but it's not that identifiable. Maybe it's not actually a game people have played. Oh, well. Skyrim, no. TF2, no. Final Fantasy, no. Final Fantasy VII, no. Mother, no. Mario, oh, no. Sounds familiar, no. Papa's Pizzeria, no. Also, Nicole! Hitman 3, no. Turok, no. Fallout, no. Wow, nobody's guessed it. Fantasy Life. It's a really big franchise. And if somebody guesses the franchise, Pokemon! Dredgy got it. This is from Pokemon Shuffle. Yeah. It's Puerto Blanco from Pokemon Shuffle for the Nintendo 3DS. Yeah! Oh, also, I blacked out. Is he done his recipe yet? This is just so much. Is this a new thing? He did. Sorry, I got distracted and stupid. Wow, look at him go. Do we want to mark off actually good? It's so much for so little. Like, that's fancy as fuck, but I mean, it'd be tasty. It's literally just chocolate. It's fucking just chocolate, which I want to say is too much chocolate. That's too much chocolate. I also want to mark off Carb Nightmare because it's just a shit ton of sugar. So you got to kind of take a stretch with a lot of these dessert ones. And I think it would take way too long to prep. It's way too long to prep. I think the plating is okay. Sorta. I mean, if you look at it, it's kind of like, fuck my scenes. It's kind of like a porcupine thing. Oh, yeah, unsanitary. Thank God you guys are here to remember these things. I'm already blanking. We've almost got a straight line, but I don't know if there's going to be a dessert that uses meat. Probably not. Talking pie, thank you so much for following the channel. Actually good. Do we want to do it? Do we want to mark off actually good? I will do it if you think it is. Dairy nightmare. There was a lot of milk. There was a lot of milk and a lot of milk chocolate. I'm doing it. Dangerous. Yeah. Nah. Kinda. Yes. I'm doing it. It's actually good.
They look like Guy Fieri if he dyed his hair black.
Yeah, kinda. It's a bit big, but I don't think it's too huge of a portion. I think it's a shareable dessert. I think two people could eat one of these. It's kind of cool. Please fill your cup. Watching it glitch out is making me mad. I'll just move it. There you go. It's out of frame. I will instead put this one kazoo there.
Make a scene just for showing music sour PLS.
I should, Jesus. This is a track from God of War 2. It's the Colossus fight. What I should do is just have something read out all the songs that I'm playing so you can look them up yourself. But I really love having a guessing game of songs. Cocoa powder. Maybe I could toggle it on and off. Vegetable oil. And then, so he's just making big chalky pallets. Oh, it's like burnt. Oh, I don't know if I like this. That doesn't look good. It's like a chocolate crepe that's not good. This guy is too into crepes. The song is so overkill, right? I really don't like his hair. His hair's a bit out there.
Oh. Shut your mouth and look at my wand.
Okay.
Land me on that corner of your desk.
I think it'd be taking up too much of the frame, but let's do it. I love you, Aunt May. Alright.
Looks leathery.
There, she's waving at you. Are you making your own Twinkies? Oh, that's not gonna shut. Oh. Oh, so much cream. Oh.
What lord is that, Dom?
What, who, how? It's Aunt May. It was the Colossus from his sister. Okay. Look at that. Choco blast it. Oh, a little more cocoa. There wasn't enough. Great. Looks good. Ugh. Oh, it's like splitting. Ugh. And then you take a chocolate. Yeah.
Happy Mother's Day, Aunt May. You are the comic book mom that we all wanted. Also, drink more cummy drinky for Aunt May.
Well, we're gonna have to once we get another bingo. I don't know if she's the mom we always... Again, I do like to harken back to the fact that this Aunt May... It shows her
holding a gun to Spider-Man's head going, "Get away from me, you freak! I'll shoot! I'll fucking do it!" So I don't know if shouting out Aunt May for Mother's Day is the best thing. Is Aunt Gary Busey. Yeah, she's great. She's one of the best. She's one of the best. Anywho, yeah, it's like a really fucked up Swiss roll. I don't know if I'd say it's a fancy Swiss roll. I think it's a fucked up, not so good Swiss roll. What do we think? What do we think about this one? I mean, I feel like I'd enjoy eating it, but I also feel like it's gross. Like, really gross. Dairy overload. That's a good one. Let's do that. Let's mark that at least. Where was that? Did we already do that? Yeah, we already did Dairy Nightmare. Overcooked. I don't know if it is. Is it? Does look like big poop. Imagine their cream was ranch. No, it's not you. Neil, thank you for the host. Looks gross. Yeah. Yeah, let's just mark it off as looks gross because it kind of looks like poop. Comical plating. Yeah, it's excessive. Let's at least mark those two and continue. I feel like the desserts don't get as many bingos because we don't have enough squares for them. Oh, can we get that little squish shot again? I don't like the squidge. I don't like the squidge, dude. Come me squish out. Ew. Looks like mashed potato. It does. Like a really rich mashed potato. Yuck. Okay, well, let's keep going. Skip, skip, skip. It's a lot of chocolate. Okay. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Why even bother? Yeah, I wasn't going to say anything. I think you're right, Bearlack. His hair is very, product. I fucking love this Mega Man jam. There was a Canadian show. There was a Canadian show surrounding... It's 100% video games, and it was a show where a bunch of kids play video games and, like, battled each other for money, and this was the song they used for their opening. And I fucking love it. It is forever in my mind as one of the best video game songs ever. This looks disgusting, by the way. Okay, here we go. He's making some other sugar shit. No, it's a good amount of butter. What are you guys thinking? Like Nick Arcade, but not. Yeah, it was Canadian Nick Arcade. I forget what it was called. It was something really generic, like video game top 10. I hope somebody knows what I'm talking about. I think BitLife knows. This is just a buttery mess. And that's all it is. They do look kind of tasty. Fuck. They're like little stuffy boys. And then they're gonna Choco Blast them. Look at that. Good night, TJ Lions. Yeah, it's just little cream puffs, but on sticks? Why three sticks? Gotta get the Chef's Club ice cream, dude. That's the only ice cream I eat. This is horrible. This is the stupidest thing. Oh, it was Video and Arcade Top 10. That's the one. Okay, I'm gonna look up Video and Arcade Top 10 in just a second. Can you guys think about what the problem with putting ice cream in a basket full of holes is? Can anyone tell me what the issue would be if you took ice cream and then you put it in a basket full of holes?
And while you all think about that, I'm going to just pause. This is my Canadian childhood, and I would watch the show all the fucking time whenever it came on the air, because Video and Arcade Top 10 was a goddamn bop. Oh, it's so quiet. Do they ever drop, or is it just this? Is it? I forgot about this. Can we see the show? I don't know. Is there any more to this? This is 14 minutes. This goes for 14 minutes. How is this 14 minutes long? Weird. Anyways, here's part of the show.
Get your digits primed and prepare to enter the newest dimension of game technology.
Whoa!
Prepare yourself against master champions, and remember, the player on the highest level is always the winner.
It
Mumbo
is.
Jumbo to some serious game action.
What do you say?
The player on the highest level is always the winner. Mumbo jumbo to some serious game action to you. Video and Arcade is next.
Do you say mumbo jumbo to sub? Oh, here we go. This is. For those who don't know, YTV was a kids' channel in Canada.
Just play some old Nickelodeon cartoon openings, Plaza.
I'm fucking tempted to. Show the show! Do the intro, show the show! This is the origin of esports. It starts in Canada. There he is! There's the guy. Look at him all, so 90s.
Hey, Game Masters, you know who I am. That's
Game
right.
Masters.
I'm Nicholas Pickles, and this is
Nicholas
the
Pickles.
We're here once again to enhance your game skills.
I love you, Nicky Picky.
And heighten your viewing enjoyment with flicks on the big screen and hot new video releases.
Nick, his name
to tell the people what else we're up for today.
Well, you guys must know by now the
Look at her!
Prizes we give away here on B&A. If you want a chance to get your mitts on one of those hot items, join us here in studio or become a home player. Now you can
the
win
hat.
This
she looks great. Shut up.
XR100 dirt bike from Honda.
Dirt bike!
And let us know why you deserve to boot around on this fully loaded speed machine. Nicholas, the address, please.
The address is Video and Arcade Top 10, 550 Queen Street East, Suite 330, Toronto, Ontario, M5A1V2. Don't forget to address it to Honda Dirt Bike. And don't worry if you didn't get the address this time. We'll flash it again for you later in the show. Now
nice.
Let's check in with the crew.
Here's the show.
I'll report news on Mario Paint on
Ebert.
This week's update. Plus, we'll take a peek at the Flick Cop in a Hat.
Okay.
Hey, I'm Rob, and I'll be invading
Dude,
the
B&A so cool.
set for the next couple of weeks while Gord's on the lam. Crank up the volume, because today we'll hear from the Waltons and Ian Don.
Konami is on the screen and kicking with two brand new fantastic Super NES games, Batman and Cybernator.
I love this show so much.
I went over to Wayne Manor earlier today, you know, have a little chit-chat with Bruce, invite him out to play.
Cool.
More like kick butt. You see, Bruce and I got a call from Gotham City. Seems there's a bunch of clowns causing a bit of trouble down there in the plaza.
Holy
Not for
shit.
Long, because we're going to play Batman Returns. Konami's
Whoa.
Kicking new games
yeah, you can say butt.
On Super NES. Are you ready? This is going to be good. Let's go over and meet our four Dark Knights.
Feed or meet.
Brandon, how you doing?
Look at these
kids. Good. Who do you
want to say hi to? He's a game player. He looks like he's held a gunpoint.
I too. Friends at St. Margaret's.
Perfect. You are playing with Chris Stafford from.
He's so
Quebec.
Scared.
Your name,
I feel
please?
So out of touch with the youth of today.
And who do you want to say hi
what
to
are
today?
They even saying? I need a translator.
These kids, dude.
Cool.
I don't know.
Your home player is Marlon West of Ajax, Ontario.
Josh, nice. Are you excited?
Yes.
Okay, who do you want to play with?
Family friends.
Okay, yes. You're playing with Steven Medeiros of Ottawa, Ontario.
Whoa.
Aaron, who do you want to say hi to?
I guess my family.
Your family, cool. But your player at home is Mike Rollins, and
are
he's
these guys on Adderall
Columbia.
Or cocaine? Because holy shit, are they speaking
today.
Really
We're
fast?
We're gonna pick the winner
this
by
is where I learned how to
the
talk.
With the most points wins. Now you gotta conquer the Red Triangle gang, players,
oh, yeah.
And you'll have
to gotta conquer the Red Triangle.
Let's turn around and play the
Hashtag
game. Liza, please tell us what we're playing for.
Our third and fourth place contestants will take home a cool t-shirt from LA Gear. Today's runner-up
Whoa.
Will be wearing a way cool Indigo watch from Timex with the luminescent face. And
Digital
our winner
watch.
Is like
partner,
G4 TV?
Walk out and pick up
but for kids.
Batman Returns to play on SNES. Now back to more game action.
All right, so here's the score. The game starts down in Gotham Plaza.
Yeah,
where the
they
red
just line up a bunch of kids in front of tube TVs and let them play.
Clowns.
I get it. Nice joke. Now these clowns, they're scaring the kids.
Try so hard for you.
They want to kill each other.
Going to give Batman the holy scrambled eggs fit.
It sure will. But he can take these guys on no problem. He has more important people to take care of.
Mm-hmm. After Batman's done with the clowns, he faces Catwoman and the Penguin. Now, poor Penguin, he only wants to find out his human name.
Anyways, this whole show was like. These two co-hosts would, like, upsell the game so kids wanted to buy it, and then kids in the background would, like, play the game, and then they'd win the big prize. And that was the whole show. Whoa! A little bit loud. Amazing show. Love this show. Can we see who wins? Yeah, let's skip to who wins. I don't even know how you calculate the points. What is this? I forget these segments. Wait, let's pause my music for a second. What is this?
There's even a mania level.
It is a genius show idea. It was like a commercial show.
Oh, Liza, let's go over and see what Nintendo tips that Clips Invader.
Oh yeah, he had Nintendo tips.
Hey gamers, it's time for another segment of Nintendo tips. Today we're gonna take a look at the mega popular game Super Mario Land 2 for play on Game Boy. Now this is a quick action game, and you've got to stay on your toes to succeed. But here are some tips to make things just a little bit easier for you. Some of the items that appear during the game will make Mario more powerful. Okay. Take advantage of them. For example, the mushroom will...
Sometimes there's power-ups in your video game, and guess what, gamers? You should make use of them.
Turn you into, of course, Super Mario. Now, if Mario grabs a fire flower, he will turn you into, well, what else? Fire Mario. By pressing the B button, Mario can lob fireballs and destroy enemies. But beware, some enemies cannot be destroyed by the fireballs.
I think he's reading the instruction manual.
Now, also, when Mario has been transformed into Super or Fire Mario,
he's stuttering.
Him spin jump by pressing on the control pad during a jump.
Just pressing on it?
If Mario finds a carrot, he will become Bunny Mario. This means he will become airborne when he flaps his big old ears. Not mine. Well, maybe he won't go into orbit, but when you jump and hold down the A button, he will float slowly to the ground. Now, another thing to look forward to is the star. When Mario gets his mitts on it, he will become invincible for 15 seconds. Well, that's about it for now. Let's head over to Nick and Liza, that crazy pair, for more game action.
One of my favorite in jokes at work for the longest time was like a video game show host, and his like game in-game tip was like, looks like you're on a spaceship, gamer. Use that to your advantage, and then it would cut. That was this guy! That was this joke in a man.
Now, Liza, I'm a DJ at heart, and this game has 19 different music tracks you can find. Of course, I do it in stereo. Really gets you
Shut your mouth and look at my wand.
Does that say Shrek?
Thank you for reading me the game instructions, Johnny Bravo.
Dude, first appearance of Shrek was in a Batman game.
You're cool. Well, the game.
You're cool.
I do it in stereo. It really gets you into the game.
You're cool.
The game,
we cannot forget about our players here. They're doing well, but let's help them with some tips to rack up those points.
Okay, tips. The bad guys will up on you, so use the cape sweep to counterattack. You can knock down all of them.
Yeah, I forgot about how bad this show was. Anyways, I'm going to skip ahead to the winner. I think they just play the games for, like, the entirety of the show, and then they just fill air. What is this?
So lays the Pioneer top five out for you.
There are some great new LaserDiscs happening on this week's list at number 5.
LaserDisc!
The Little Engine That Could at number 4, The Grass Is Greener. At number 3, Mistress starring Robert De Niro and Danny Aiello at...
Did they just recommend a LaserDisc movie called Mistress to a bunch of kids? What is Mistress? What is this movie? Wait a fucking minute. Why would any child want to see the movie? What was this rated? Is it called Mistress?
Number 2, Little Ninjas, and at number 1, Leprechaun. They're small.
No! You can't recommend children Leprechaun on LaserDisc. What is wrong with you? Oh my god! Holy shit! I'm losing my mind. Oh my god. Yeah, Canadian kid shows were fun. They were a good time.
Irish. They're hiding pots of gold all over the place, and they're number one on the Pioneer Top 5. What little creatures am I talking about? I know you have the answer, so hurry it up and send it in, and you might just win two laser discs courtesy of Pioneer. Johnny De Podesta of Port Carling, Ontario did because he knew that Woody Allen directed the movie Husbands and Wives. Congrats, Johnny. Your laser discs are in the mail. Well, here's your chance.
Anyways, this was a time before Google.
Just stretch, but keep an eye on the set, because when we come back, we'll see which of our players is the top Dark Knight. See you in a bit.
The fuck is a Laserdisc? Laserdisc was the competitor to DVD. Laserdisc was a, like, you know what a DVD? It was like a record-sized DVD.
Honorable mentions, Chucky. IT stars a cute little doll.
This is like a fun little doll. Kids love dolls. YTV had news?
Liza, our Dark Knights are at rest. Tell us which of the players kicked the most bad guy butt in Batman Returns.
Yeah, get
well,
that
Nicholas,
butt!
Well, our winner today is player number two, Joshua.
Joshua!
Go, Joshua, and he'll be doing a little space traveling with this double pass to the space race at the CN Tower. Add to that a little rock and rolling with the Bittersweet and Twisted CD, the newest CD from the London group, the Choir Boys. And if you're in mind for a little adventure,
Quail
how about
Boys?
X-Men, the board game from Playtoy, plus this game, Caddy, from Fidelity Electronics to keep your Nintendo library in order.
Ew.
Congratulations and thank you to everyone for coming out and playing the game. Now for a little insight into the world of video games.
He looks so unhappy.
Lexa and the Nintendo
he has a crush
update
on the female co-host.
And now for something completely different. It's a departure from the action, adventure, and sports games you're used to. I'm talking about an innovative graphics program that lets you design scenes, compose music, create animation, and even combine all three.
Are you talking about Mario Paint?
You know what it is, right? Exactly. Mario Paint. This program gives you a wide range of choice for what you want to do when you're feeling creative, so experiment. The icons that run along the bottom of the screen when you start the game represent the game's
again,
different
the show
modes
was an ad.
And options. To check them out, move your cursor onto each and click once. Yeah. You'll open areas that let you design stands, music, animate frames, create illustrations,
Super Mario Kart.
Add color to previously sketched scenes. I know. So many choices, so little time.
I know, yeah.
Well, I thought we'd focus in on the animation option this time and move into other modes on a later episode. Lights, camera, action. When you add animation to your artwork, it comes alive on the screen. After you create a background in the drawing mode, jazz it up by designing some action to put onto your scene.
The girl in the suit jacket was the star of a Friday the 13th sequel where Jason is up in space.
Decide what you wanted to do.
Really?
And put it together with the background and music so you can
Jason in space.
Effect.
You can she was in that movie.
Across the screen by choosing the path
what was that
off
called?
The animation mode and setting a course
Jesus,
for the action.
Jesus, that's wild.
It's a
she was. I can't believe that.
You want to make it, so it's
I can't believe that. Jason X. Yeah. I've seen that. I haven't seen the movie. Is it this woman? This woman was in Jason. She was the lead in Jason X? What the fuck?
Contestants.
So what does it mean when I say Konami's in the house? I'll tell you what it means. It means action, action, and more action. It's the 21st century. Marines have become mechanized. They stand five stories
tall. They're in the house.
They carry the most advanced in weaponry. Get set for Konami's Super
Konami
NES game Cybernator. The battle is against
one
weaponry.
More time.
Get set for Konami's Super NES game Cybernator. The battle is against the Axis forces, and the battle is now. Our players here are Cybernator recruits. When they're ordered to put on the Cybernator assault suit, they take control of a Cybernator G5E. Now, all five stories of it are included. Enough said, let's go meet our four recruits.
There it is.
Aaron, you looking forward to this?
Yep.
So you're excited?
Yep.
Cool. Who do you want to say hi to?
Paul from Clips and my fellow classmates.
He's here right now, Paul from Clips. Marcus Savard is your home player of London, Ontario.
Oh. Mark, who do you want to say hi to?
Anna, Chris, my friends, family, and Paul from Clips.
Perfect. Your home player is James Lynch Jr. of Gould, Newfoundland.
Can you tell Paul put some money up today for these hellos? Jackie, how you doing?
Fine.
Who do you want to say hi to?
Just my family and my friends.
Not Paul from Clips?
Nope.
All right. And you're playing with Adam
I like that. That was
of
cute.
Dorian, Quebec.
Paul, who you want to say hi to today?
To my friends and family.
Is this Paul from Clips?
That's it.
Perfect. Your home player is Mark Levere of Sydney, Nova Scotia. All right.
Was that Paul from
all
Clips?
Our players in studio today. The winner of Cybernator
shout out to Paul Jorgen in chat.
Highest points. That is, if anyone survives the next 10 minutes of lightning-paced action. Recruits, put on
lightning
your Cybernator assault suits.
Hate.
Turn around and play the game. Liza, please, what will our survivors get?
Our third and fourth place contestants take home a very hip new shirt from LA Gear.
Woo!
Up against this very cool Iron Man Indiglo watch, courtesy of Timex. It can even light your weight in the darkness with its luminescent face. And our winner and their play-at-home partner will each get a copy of Konami's Cybernator for playing on SNES. Now, let's head over to more game action.
I won Super Smash Bros. By writing into the show. No fucking way.
Three-peater enemy eliminator.
That makes me so happy.
The eliminator can
I always
fire
wanted
both
to get something. Never sent me anything.
Beams and homing missiles. When an enemy's near, try okay, the
so
knuckleizer. The Cyberator's crushing
punch. Knuckleizer? Anyways, I'm going to skip ahead because who cares? It's just, they literally just sell the game. Oh, more tips, more tips, more tips!
Nick Prairie meets acoustic pop, you betcha. Hailing from Regina, Saskatchewan, the Waltons have become
Regina.
An overnight sensation since their trio first got together in 1987. Since then,
what?
The group has been nominated for various CASBY Awards, including Best Debut Album, and performed with the likes of great bands like The Hip and Bare Naked Ladies. From the album Like My Tractor, here they are with Colder Than You.
The funniest thing is this show probably isn't going to get me a DMCA strike, but that song might. Some butt rock. We're going to skip ahead. Yeah. Okay, and we're going to skip ahead again. This is a cool thing. I guess they're doing it on MTV. I kind of dig it.
Oh. Yo, 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 Prince B and DJ Minimix are two hip-hop poets making the world of rap spin. This funky duo is better known as PM Don and the Rocketeer to
yo,
the top
yo,
of the charts
yo.
With their debut album Of the Heart and Of the Cross, The Utopian Experience. Yeah. PM Don recently completed album number 2, The Bliss Album, but right now, here they are with a single from their debut album, check out Plastic.
Okay, so Plastic, this is the song that's turning the hip-hop rap world on its head in 1993. You know what? This is going a lot harder than I would have expected for a children's show, but let's keep going. Ooh. Damn! I'm digging this! What the fuck?
Hey, pretty funky. If you'd like to win a Primo prize, namely a cassette, write in and tell me the name of PM Don's second album.
You could get a cassette.
PM Don, care of Video and Arcade, Top 10, 550 Queen Street, East Suite 330, Toronto, Ontario, M5A1V2. Hey, Joey Farrell of Woodstock, New Brunswick, and Paul Edwards of Grimsby, Ontario, have won a Lenny Kravitz CD for writing in and telling
Lenny
us that
Kravitz.
Name of his new album, which is Are You Gonna Go My Way? I hope so. Way to go. Let's check in with our Warriors
so. Anyway,
and
bye.
See what's happening with, just for you, Nick, Cybernators.
Cybernators!
All right, let's move on to stage 2, the Asteroid Defense Force.
The mission here is to find
okay.
the Ark Nova. Make
Turn
your
into
way to the Asteroid Defense
Force. Oh, we're back to Nicholas Pickles.
The pleasure of the letter of the day with Nicholas the Pickles.
It's my very favorite part of the show. It's letter time. This one comes to us, and it's a dice. It's a sliced, serrated letter. Thank you very much. Jason Edwards, Marystown, Newfoundland. Jason writes, Dear Video and Arcade Top 10. Hi, my name is Jason Edwards. I'm 9 years old. I'm in grade 4. I watch your show every weekend, and I really like it. Thank you. My favorite Super NES games are Super Mario World, Turtles in Time, and RoboCop 3. Please put me on the home player list. Thank you very much, your friend Jason. Hey, Jason, I'm your friend, too. Thanks for writing in because you took the time to do it. We're going to send you a Rogers Video gift certificate. That's good for 10, count them, 10 rentals of movies or video games. Pretty wild, no? Plus, I want to encourage you viewers to send in pictures, drawings, or anything.
There were lines of coke done on this show. Absolutely.
A little bit more homey, so come on, help me out. Don't go away. We have not yet announced the winner of Cybernators, so stick around.
I bet the producer was always like, talk fast, talk fast. Talk as fast as you can. Children have no attention span. Keep talking. Scream at them if you can.
Dreamland Action, the V&A top 3 games right. chosen by you, our viewers, are at number 3, Kirby's Dreamland. At number 2, Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego?
Okay.
At number 1, our viewers choose Wayne's World.
Makes sense.
And now for our game tip question. In Kirby's Dreamland, how can Kirby eliminate Poppy Brothers Sr. in the first stage, Green Greens?
What,
James Cook of St. John's
There's a lot of ways to do that,
Nintendo
right?
game for knowing that the golden coin in the tree zone in Super Mario Land 2 is under the bird inside the egg. Keep sending in your vote for your fave game. We love it.
That was such a video game sentence.
Guru, Lexa.
The coin was under the bird, in the egg, under the bridge. And Joe!
A wisecracking kid who's witness to a crime pairing with a cranky but big-hearted cop. And what have you got? A hit. At least that's what the cast of Cop and a Half hopes. Norman D. Golden 2 stars as the kid who won't give evidence until the police give him a badge and let him become an investigator on the case. The cop is movie and television star Burt Reynolds, directed by Henry Winkler. You know him as the Fonz and Happy Days.
Kazoos.
This is a fast-action comedy that's a hit. Kids of all ages
Thank
will
you,
enjoy.
Enzo.
Take a look.
Kids never pick on me. Yeah. Got a witness.
Holy shit, I forgot this was a movie.
Where is he?
You need me to testify and identify, right?
I don't think I like that.
Yeah, it's literally this. I forget this actor's name. I forget it. But yeah, literally, it's just him and a kid. And the kid's like, I'm a cop too. And he's like, Jesus, fuck, you're a child. I'm Burt Reynolds. Let me be a cop. And the kid's like, no, I'm a cop too. And that's the whole movie.
Question one.
Thank you, Burt Reynolds.
Like
yeah, yeah.
What?
He wants to be a cop.
Yeah, it's a buddy cop movie with a child.
Of my still forming lungs may be shriveling into green chunks of mucus.
We've got a pair of Cineplex Odeon movie passes that could come your way if you can tell me the answer to this. Henry Winkler directed this movie. He was once also a popular actor. Can you name the television series that made him a star?
I don't know.
Those answers in and we'll show you the address at the end of the show. The winner of our Star Trek
directed by the Fonz, I guess, yeah.
Of Toronto, Ontario, because he knew that the Starship Enterprise was accused of firing on a peaceful Klingon vessel. Way to go, Christopher. You've just won two movie passes courtesy of Cineplex Odeon Theaters.
Oh.
Now let's head back over to Nikolai Piccolai and the winner of Cybernator.
Well, it was an exciting game, but as you know, there can only be one winner. Lies, which one of our players can call themselves the champ of Cybernator?
This was an excellent game, and our winner
here we go.
Is player number four, Paul.
Paul!
Way to go.
Wait,
our
what did she do?
Is player number four, Paul. All right, Paul, congratulations. You are taking home our V&A prize pack, which is totally loaded for some action. How about this regulation-sized footloose soccer ball, courtesy of Spalding.
Soccer!
And for some indoor action, Golden Games will keep you and your friends busy with the Rubik's Dice Puzzle and the party game
Elfers. They gave him a Rubik's Cube?
The clock with fast talking, then chill out with the CD from Duran Duran featuring
the latest
hit,
Come Undone. They gave him a speedboard?
And we'll throw in a Nintendo speedboard from Fidelity Electronics.
They gave him a fucking speedboard!
Out and play in the game today. Nicholas,
I know this is really fucking stupid. I want to show you guys what a speedboard is. They're the stupidest thing in the entire world. Here is, this is so fucking stupid. Here is a, oh God, come on, copy image link. Here's a speedboard. It's a lump of plastic and you put an NES controller in it so you can hit the buttons real quick. It puts the speed at your fingertips. Imagine a big lump of plastic you put an Xbox controller in so that you can't hold it and you gotta do this. That's what a speedboard is. It's the worst thing. I can't believe they gave this poor child a speedboard and a soccer ball and a Rubik's Cube. Dude, he is not happy. That is the face of a man that has been defeated.
And a big round
He's biting his lip like, oh, fuck, I hate all those
today.
Things.
Nicholas.
We hope you guys all had fun with us here in studio and glad.
Was it actually, was it a Duran Duran CD?
I'm
sorry, my bad.
That's bullshit. Just spring for the NES Advantage and turn the turbo on.
Right? Why would you ever use a speedboard when a turbo button exists?
Nintendo game
tuned in. If you'd like to come in and compete as a studio player,
what a bad.
It's area code 416-203-2176.
Anyways, I love the show.
Drop us a letter. Video on our
Absolutely love the show.
Suite 330, Toronto, Ontario, M5A1B2. Remember, whether you're clowning around in Gotham City or five stories tall with a destruction complex, it all comes down to the same thing. Play the game. Guys,
play the game. Guys, let's
Nintendo
have more fun.
Hot game action. Now you're playing with power.
Woo!
Superpower.
Yeah, this show ran until 2006. I think I watched it in the very late 90s and early 2000s.
CompuCenter, the personal computer specialist.
I really wanted to be on this show.
Your needs a computer.
Really, really, really wanted to. This and were the two shows I wanted to be on as a kid.
Oxynite Watch works.
What's the last?
Unclog pores and help prevent pimples. Oxycute your pimples with Oxynite Watch.
Let's see, do you think there's a Video and Arcade Top 10, like, newest episode? Like, what episode would that have been? Like, the 2006 episode? Oh, man, I have no idea. Look at this kid. Oh, this was actually the person that was on the show! My shirt, 15 minutes of fame. I was not wise wearing a blaring red shirt at the time. Aww. And his parents recorded it because he was on TV. Oh, this is when they got rid of Nicholas Pickles, wasn't it? Oh, man. No, there he is! I'm not going to play this whole thing. I just want to see the kid. This child is two. Look at him. Look at how tiny he is compared to the other boys.
this. He's a little baby. They got a baby on this show.
Worked out before?
Yeah.
Yeah, do you like it?
Yeah.
Good work, so you're pretty good at it.
Yeah.
Okay, good luck today. You're pretty
Yeah. Yeah.
What happened to the cool outfit?
I don't know. They gave up.
Playing with Evan Gosiel from Three Hills, Alberta.
Michael, how you doing?
Fine.
Is there anyone you want to say hi to up there?
Yeah, hi to my best friend, Brandon.
Oh, he's saying hi to his best friend. Yeah. Yeah.
Adam 100% fucks.
Then he grew up to be the world's most notorious playboy. I still don't see anyone in a red shirt. I think this is the first segment, and then they're going to kick into the second segment with the other kids after the first ones win. Come on, show the new contestants. All right, here we go. This is the last. That's the tall kid! The tall kid uploaded this video.
Hi to everyone in St. Philip Pocock Secondary School, which I attend, and especially Francis, Gerald, Chris, all of them, and the Bantam Boys basketball team.
Excellent, great news.
Nice.
I can't hear a word he's saying.
Roger Pennell from Lipissi, Newfoundland.
All right, Josh, are you the King of Zelda or what?
Yeah.
You think so?
Yeah, please, yes.
My family and friends.
All right, good luck. You're playing with Manny.
Andy Bro! Andy Bro, thank you for the tier one sub, buddy.
No, you're looking forward to it?
Yeah.
Could be exciting.
Ira! I got a kazoo for me to you.
Some friends? No? Okay, you're playing with Michael A. Pierre from Britain.
I've got a better one.
All right, Jason, how good are you, Zelda?
Pretty good.
Pretty good. You think you'll beat these guys?
That's Jason! That's Jason! That's the man that uploaded this video in 2019! How old... Oh, fuck. How old is he? How old is he now? Is he like a 30-year-old? Man. Holy shit. I cannot believe it. That he saved this footage and then uploaded it now. He's so fucking tall. He is! Man, I almost want to click on his channel. Look at all the other stuff Jason does. He was on Video on Arcade. Oh, he tweets about Fury. Oh, he plays Binding of Isaac! He's a man of my heart. Does he do... Oh, is this him? Oh, man. Holy shit. He's like a fucking man. He's a full man. That's crazy. Oh, and he does Extra Life. Oh, he does streams on Twitch. I cannot believe it.
Probably.
You hope so. All right, Albert.
Wait, where is he from?
All right, now.
Just my family and friends.
Okay, good luck. You're playing with Carlos Alexander from Edmonton, Alberta. Good luck.
Oh, Edmonton! Maybe I met this guy. Anyways. I think it's time we stop looking at my childhood and start looking at life hacks. Let's get intense.
If you think he's a full man, you should see Pickles.
So what did Nicholas Pickles grow up to be? No! Okay, wait. Can we get an image of Nicholas Pickles? This is old Nick Pick from Video and Arcade. This is Nicholas Pickles now. This is the most LinkedIn profile photo I've ever seen, and he's like big dad. He's a dad. Absolutely a dad. Dude's a dad. He hasn't aged a day. I can't believe it. And he's got like the same haircut too. Big dad energy. Yeah, sitcom dad vibes. Absolutely. I wish I could show you his tie. I'd have to scroll it out. He does look like a politician. I wonder how old he is. I wonder how old he was here. Do you think he was in his early 20s? Maybe mid-20s? I am very distractible on alcohol. I mean, when I don't get many opportunities to talk about Video and Arcade Top 10, so I just jumped at it. I had to. There's only one thing I want to do before getting off of this topic and getting back to the actual meat and potatoes of this fucking broadcast. I want to see what the last episode looked like. Girl, Papa! Thank you.
He fucks for sure.
Somebody made a video. Somebody made a video. Their name is Game Display. Alright, come on! Hey! Oh, Andy! Andy, thank you for gifting a sub to Chief. Chief! Welcome back to the Kazoo Crew. I hope you enjoy your stay. Yeah! Somebody uploaded a video that is them talking about the time they were on Video and Arcade.
Hello everyone, Andrew here, and welcome to today's video where I thought it'd be fun to commentate over an episode of the Canadian game show Video and Arcade.
Oh my god.
Gathering in the back alley.
Oh, HL wow. Switch again. This was uploaded in 2020. I don't know why, it just warms my heart that other people remember this fucking nonsense show. Here's a later episode. Here's a 763. And I think it's the same.
With seven brain-baffling challenges.
Why is the audio in my left ear and crusty?
The game of fast reflexes and rapid recall. Compliments of our friends at Hasbro.
Oh.
Nice going, big round one.
Oh, this guy! Back to you, Leah. Is that Nicholas? Wait, is that Nicholas Pickles? Wait. Wait a minute. That can't be him, right?
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Video and Arcade Top.
I've... I didn't know that he turned into a dad while he was doing the show. I didn't know that he turned into a dad while he was doing the show. He was... He... 40 hit him hard. Is he 40? This show only ran for like 10 years. It looks like he aged 30 years. In the span of like 10. The show was actually 15 years, but like, he aged a lot in 15 years. He, like, this looks like a guy. I swear to God, I'm not picking on him. I'm just stating facts here. He looks like somebody that went from the age of 15. He looks like he could be 15 here. And then he jumped to like mid 40s, early 50s if he was healthy. Early 50s healthy, maybe mid-40s. That is a leap. That is a leap. You watch too much Degrassi. I've never seen an episode in my life. This is what's going to happen to all of us. That's true. It happens. I just can't imagine it happening in the span of 10 years. But maybe it's going to hit me like that. It could. Aging is a thing. The ever-ticking of the clock. Anyways, you know what? It's time to think not about that and about our mortality. Even though we all will return to dust. I think it's time we just look at some Bingy. Should we do Bingy? Thank you for sharing your childhood. You're welcome. It's quite fun. I think he was mid-20s and early 30s when the show started. He just had baby face. I think so. I think he had baby face and then he lost it. And I'll be honest. I've got a bad case of relative baby face. Imagine when that goes away. I'm going to just turn into a man. And I'm not going to look like a weird baby man anymore. I'm scared of that. I don't want that. Also, Indy, thank you for gifting us up the Nightbot. Nightbot? I hope you enjoy being a bot. I got Kazoo from Meteo. Yay. Tom has adorability privilege. It's going away, though. It goes away as you age. Trust me. Tom, man. It's going to be all the drinking I do on this cast that does me in. Anyways, let's continue. I think I had left us all on the idea of, hey, this is an ice cream basket and there's a bunch of holes in it. So, we're gonna take a second to realize that this is a terrible idea. I know it's not dangerous, but it's stupid. And you know what? Fuck it. It's in the same vein as the word dangerous. And I was speechless. Because they did a lot of work on that fucking bowl, and I don't understand what was going on. So, I think that's the end of it. Oh, yeah, too much butter. I mean, they are little like, cream puff things, but I think you're right. I think it is too much. I think it was a little bit too much butter, but that doesn't even do us a bingo. The portion is huge, too, but I think it's supposed to be shared. That's it. There's nothing else we can do. I don't think we got a single bingo on that. The dessert ones are so bereft of bingo, and it just makes me so sad. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Fucking Breath of the Wild, get out of here. His real name is Nicholas Schimmelpen. I don't believe that. No. Alright, well, we should do a separate bingo card for desserts. I mean, at this point, right? Alright, let's do this. Slash prediction. Way less than two bingos. It was less than two bingos. It was none. Oh, I can't. Oh, I was completing it. I think Bacon got it. Thank you, Bacon. Hey, guess what? New prediction. And we are going to stick to only two bingos. Or sorry, two. Yeah, greater than or less than two.
Too bad I did it.
Damn it. Stop helping so nicely. And you already started a new one. I'm going to unmod you. Okay. I also love the disparity in views. 168, 1.1 million. Like, it just fluctuates. It's crazy. It is like TikTok. Okay, anyways, fuck you, dude, Tom.
Let's start off recipe faves. I hope to God that this isn't mashed potatoes, but I'm almost... They do this a lot where they just like, I don't know, man. Like, you saw the clip that I used to advertise the stream tonight, right? The one where he turned mashed potatoes on bread. You have water, right? Yeah, you're right. I should have some water. Let me drink. Cogbiz! Thank you for the 11 months. Thank you. Aw. That's so nice of you to say. All of you will babysit me till the day I die. This is the worst kazoo. I don't know why I keep it on my desk. Also, potato sandwich. Can somebody get a link to my tweet of the potato sandwich for Saturday? Speaking of, Brownie, thank you for retweeting my tweet about the stream tonight. I think we're ready. Ooh, holy shit. A lot of people are going for less bingos this time. A lot of people are voting for less than two. Unlike prior, I don't think it's the max, though. Can I predict? Oh, I can't. Oh, I can't. I wish that I could vote. No, it doesn't let the broadcaster vote. Son of a bitch. I could have made so many beautiful beans. Even though I have infinite. Damn, 127 to 90K. Okay, you guys ready? I think we're good to go. I got the bingo card loaded up. If you have a bingo card yourselves, I recommend going to the help menu and then randomizing that SOB. And bing bada boom, you got a fresh card. Dreadfowl, thank you so much for gifting a big sub to Potato Comer. What a great name. I've got a kazoo. From me to you. Thank you. That's mashed potato. He's making mashed potato canoes. Oh, nothing like baking with a plastic bottle. Oh, he's making a little a squidger so he can do stars, I guess. Oh, okay. And it's out. Yeah. Oh. Oh, it's so lopsided. Oh. Didn't really measure it, but you know what? It's fine. He knows what he's doing. Cooked taters, bunch of butter. I don't know why you would ever add cornstarch to potatoes. Does anyone do that? When you make mashed potatoes, are you supposed to add cornstarch to it? Yeah, it is already too much prep. Alright, and there, and now he's making, oh, that looks so bad. Why bother? Alright. I've never done it. Okay, good. I had to make sure. I add potato starch to my corn. And then I make mashed corn-tatoes. Okay. Okay, it's kind of looking okay. Parsley. And here come the stars. Oh, wait, no, this is different. It's different mashy potatoes. As a binding agent. I still can't believe you would do it, though, because potatoes are basically all starch. Okay. And then you make a boat. Do you think he's going to bake these mashed potatoes that were already boiled? He's gonna bake them. He always bakes them. It's mashed potatoes loaded with beef? There's the cheese. He's absolutely gonna bake it. Oh, the star? What? Why is he doing this? Is this like Shepherd's pie logs with no veg? Nothing like mashed potatoes and lettuce. This wouldn't taste of anything. I think that this would taste like mashed potatoes. I bet you anything you wouldn't even be able to taste the meat. There's so little meat, I bet you'd only taste mashed potatoes. It's the world's worst rendition of a shepherd's pie. Terrible.
I don't even know what to say. I think worse than a frozen pizza, undeniably. And I was speechless. And the prep time is stupid. I don't know why you'd bother. Also, the comical plating. I mean, like, look at this fucking shit. Look at this. They're lined up like hot dogs laying in a bed of lettuce. Froze it and then charred it. Yeah, so you can get browning on the taters. Is it a carb nightmare? It's just potatoes, right? Overcooked too. Can you overcook mashed potatoes? I'm sure you can overcook anything, but I have no idea. Oh, also, Callisti, thank you for hosting the channel. Good if you come overdone mashed potatoes? I guess. I mean, yeah, you make the mashed potatoes and then you freeze them and then you cook them again. Yeah, fuck it. That's some version. That's some version of overcooked. I love that you can't see jack shit behind Aunt May. Should I take Aunt May down for the bingo portion? Under overcooked. And fuck it, let's mark off carb nightmare. It's just a shit ton of mashed potatoes and that's it. People do love twice baked. That's true. Are you supposed to bake them and then freeze them though? Put her in your lap. No. I don't want her to touch me. She's scary. I do hate her. Salmon? Oh. I hate when they bake in what is ostensibly garbage. Okay. And cleaning them. I guess that counts as cleaning. Parchment paper. He's almost cutting right. Almost. Okay, this would take ages, but sure. Gotta get the Chef's Club ranch mix. Ew. That kind of looks gross. Kind of looks disgusting. Uh-huh. Oh, and then you weigh it down and freeze it. What? Oh, ew. And then just zucchini scrapings. What did that say? Rests of zucchini. I honestly thought it just said rets, but rests of zucchini, sure. I think we can mark off editing for that one. Why even slice it up if it's just gonna be goo? Oh, yuck. Oh, no. Is this a thing people make? If I did that, it would splash all against the wall. What a song. Ew. Is this a thing people eat? Do people eat pasta in zucchini? This seems disgusting. No, nobody does that? No? Okay. And then there's salmon? I just wanted to make sure, because like, oh god, ew. Oh, it's just a brick of frozen salmon. That cannot be anything but over-seasoned. It looks like head cheese. Oh, ew. I'm at a loss for words. I don't know what to say about this. This doesn't look like food.
I don't know, and I'm seeing some people not fighting in chat, but like...
Hi, Tom, I just came in. I hate it.
Oh, you're welcome. Glad to have you for as little as we will. What should we do? It's a plate of penne pasta that's just cheese, cream, Alfredo sauce, kinda. And then there's zucchini in it, I guess. And then you take a half a zucchini, you core it out, and you put pasta in it, and then you put salmon lumps on it. Is zucchini Alfredo penne with salmon a thing? It's like really odd mac and cheese. I don't know if this would be good. I don't like zucchini, so... And I don't know. I mean, the fish, I think, like, salmon might be good. I don't know. The seasoning. The ranch seasoning, by the way. Ranch. Should we say looks actually good? I don't know. I really, 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 really want to say that this looks gross. It looks gross. I guess we should wait until he seasons it, but, like... It looks both really gross and really tasty. It's both. I feel like, man, that looks tasty as fuck. And also, man, this looks gross as fuck. It's exactly the same. It's both at the same time. I don't know why. It's freaking my brain out. It does feel like a hodgepodge of leftovers. Fuck it. I'm marking looks gross. I'm sorry.
Look like a lot of fingies.
They do, little fingies. Would this taste gross? I'm leaving it to chat to decide. I don't know what fetish this is, but it's something. It's fucking something. It is! I'm holding to it! Hey, Bob! One whole year! Fuck yeah! Happy anniversary, K-pop! I got a big gold kazoo from me to you! I hope you enjoy the match! Yeah, it would be good with breadcrumbs. I'm gonna say taste gross. Not gross, not good. I'm gonna lean on taste gross. I'm leaning on it, and that's all we leaning on. Avoided the RE stream to play solo. Was it any good? It was really good, Saucy, but not as good as Resident Evil 7. Really good, really fucking good game. Do not think that I don't think it's a good game. It's a great game, and I highly recommend it. Not as good as 7, but very good. Very good. Anyways, yeah, unusual ingredients. You have to buy Chef's Club ranch dressing or something. Aw, Dylan! Dylan, thank you for liking my tweet about the cast. I don't know if there's anything else. Salmon, zucchini, and ranch is a bizarre flavor profile. I can't even think of it. I can't even think of what it is. Resident Evil 7, I didn't think was that good. Ooh, you might not like this. Unless you really like Resident Evil 4. That's got some, like, Resident Evil vibes to it. In Village, I should say. Also, I gagged a little bit. I just don't like zucchini. Very personal thing. Huh. Sickening. I hate it. Ranch seasoning is okay if it's moderately used. Ugh. It was just coated. Beep. I love Village. Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, I really do want to try it, but, you know, it's weird. Awesome. I love a recipe that calls for 2 full fucking loaves of bread. White bread with the butts chopped off. Okay, sorry. 9 slices. Not quite, you know, not that much. Oh, no. You're just making a lot of really gross sandwiches, aren't you? Are you really making weird sand? Why are you stacking the... Oh, yuck. This is gonna be so nasty. Watch her throw all of it away. All the excess. She's doing it again? Those crusts ain't coming with us. Get them out of here. Those are for the birds. And they're not even... Birds aren't even supposed to eat crusts. It makes them sick and they die. We're killing birds with these. Uh-huh. What? Is this what being a chef is? Or is this madness. She's gonna put an egg on it. Yeah. Wait, are you baking the whole thing? Bacon. Okay. Wait, you're not even gonna fry the bacon separately? You're gonna let the bacon grease drip into the bread? Awesome.
Yas,
queen. Queen Yas. Zed! What up, buddy? How you fucking doing tonight? Also, thank you for the 17 months. Glad to see you. I hope you're doing better than me, because I'm scared. Is she making a bread and cheese lollipop? Wait, what? Oh, you fucking stop. Zed, can I get a shout out command for Zed, please? Oh my god, this looks just hellish. Why are you making bread cheese lollies? There it is. Go fucking check out Zed's channel. I swear to God. What? Why?
Yeah. Oh, hello.
I don't know how I feel about this one, because I like, I think this would taste good. I think that this would taste good. Also, I agree. I think the egg white is a bit runny, but the egg yolk is fine. I think I'd like this. I hate it, but I don't know. The egg would be rubber by the time the bacon is browned that much. Yeah, there's something about it. What is happening? Everybody's resubbing? Twisted Shadow with the 34, Shadowmancer with the 8, and Sloth with the 9. I got 3 kazoos. From me to the each of yous. Yous guys out there. Thank you. Well, I know this might be contentious, but I'm marking off actually good. And I'm marking off bacon. And I'm marking off bad editing for that one thing. I don't know what else we can mark off. I hit 400 followers on Twitch today. Yes, congrats. You know what? Fuck it. Cheers to you. It was 3 sandwiches. They did make a shit ton of sandwiches. We'll mark off you.
I came here for laughs, but this just made me depressed.
Yay! Woohoo! Me too! Cheers. What's the drink? Just milky cum. I'm sorry. It's actually just Milky's and soju. Milky soju. Boom, they're together at last. Also, a grit. Cummy's time. Thank you so much for the 3 months of support. Aunt May, get out of here. Aunt May, wait, let's get a close up real quick. There she is. She waves. She's waving goodbye. Aunt May is like, bye bye.
Bye bye, everybody. Bye bye. See you later.
Who would have guessed? At the age of 27, I'd be playing with dolls on the internet, live, to a couple hundred strangers. Let's put Aunt May on the ground. There we are. Let's put Aunt May. No! Stay down. There we are. Perfect. Fantastic. Anyways, only 600 strangers. That's a reasonable amount of people to see me playing with dolls. Also, hi, everybody. I don't know what we can even mark off for that. Like, look at this. Tom looks 12. Shut up. Jade! Jade, thank you so much. What the fuck? Big four months of support. I got big kazoo from me to you. In this situation, it's appropriate to say, cummy wummy for tummy tummy. Yummy yummy. And with that sentence read aloud, I shall take a sip. Fantastic. Is comical plating done? I think it is. Let me double check the card. We're just looking out for
unidentifiable meat, mixed chat mad, excessive chocolate, dangerous meat nightmare, unsanitary, dairy, or too much butter.
Hey, Tom, guess who was just granted Swedish citizenship?
Oh! Oh, that is pretty fucking cool. I've never been to Sweden, but I assume it's a good time. Fucking congrats! I don't know. I am drunk. I don't know if there's anything I can do about this. I don't know if there's anything we can add. There's no excessive chocolate. Wait, was there chocolate in the... Wait, was the egg basket on this one? No, that was before. They did the zucchini pasta, and then they did... Wait, was that all they did? They had two recipes. Wait, did they only have two recipes? Oh, no, they had the shitty shepherd's pie, which was just mashed potatoes with a little bit of ground beef in it, covered in more mashed potatoes, and then you bake it, and then that was it, and then it ended. Yeah, that was bad, too. I forgot about it. But, yeah, the chocolate thing was the other episode. Damn. Did they identify every meat? Let's double check. I don't know if they... I think they said it was ham, right? When they laid it out, they're like, this is ham. Cheese. Ham. Oh, did you see that edit where it comes up and then it comes up again? I don't know why these are so poorly produced, but there it is. They got ham. They said ham. I'm not a ham, Ray Ray. How could you say that about me? Did they identify what type of fish was used? They did say it was salmon. And they said the ground beef was ground beef. So, I think the meats are all counted for. Oh, that's a compliment. Oh, is it? I don't know what ham means. But I'll take it. Thank you. I don't think there's anything we can mark off. I think that might have been one bingo. I'm sorry to say it to everybody that did two bingies. Dangerous for blood pressure. I hate to say, I think my mind has been changed on this one. While I don't think it's feasible to be able to cook eggs and bacon at the exact same time and get the bacon crispy and the eggs runny, I don't think that's a possibility. I love this. It looks kind of good. It's kind of good. I mean, I already marked off actually good. Yeah, the bacon wouldn't be crispy. You'd have to do them separately. So I don't know why they lied there, but oh well. Maybe we can mark off something else to like imply, oh, this isn't possible. This isn't real. I'm sorry to say, guys, but I think the card's done. I think this card's done unless we can find a way to mark off dangerous. I mean, that egg's pretty runny. You could probably get a disease. Crispy bacon's disgusting. Dude, I love bacon that's like crispy and chewy at the same time. Didn't they put a fuck ton of butter between each layer? No. Tekinesi. That's a really hard name to say while you're drunk. Tekinesi. I think it was bechamel. Wasn't it bechamel sauce? I also don't know what bechamel is. Is it butter? Is it mostly butter? Chewy bacon, better than crispy. It really is pretty good. Chat mad. I don't know if chat's mad. We're pretty content, I think. Crispy bacon is the only way to eat it, really. Dangerous for my asshole. Uh-oh. Don't put it in there. Also, Suki, thank you for liking my tweet about the cast. Give me beans. Yeah, we did it. We're less than two, everybody. I think it's time we move on. We have one final recipe. And I'll be honest, I am scared of it because it's called Cheese Mania. And these people are batty with cheese. If you haven't yet, take your time, refresh your bingy card, mark off your free space, and I'm gonna just start the video, but I'm not gonna play it. That's not cheese. Uh-oh. Already a bit of a pickle. Ooh. Here, I'm gonna just do this. I don't even need to listen to this. I mean, I can hear the songs if I crank my headphone monitor. Whew! It's not a pickle either. No! Something's wrong. I don't know what it is. Are they using a... They are using a little fingy condom. Dude, they don't want to get those peppers pregnant. Damn, 51,000 beans to 49K. It's almost even. Are you supposed to... Why only one finger? Why do they have one finger covered?
others not? I don't,
what's the point? Is there any point to having one condom finger? He probably cut his finger. Oh, you're right. He probably has like a little boo-boo and he's like, I don't wanna. I'm not getting the peppy. I'm not getting the zesty in my fingy hole. Fingy hole. Jesus Christ. Well, we've got 108,000 beans up against 18,700 beans. Fuck me. I think we start this shit show right off. Here we go, guys. Do you think they just cheesed it? Those are tomatoes? What's wrong with them? I thought they were peppers. Okay, I already hate this. Oh, ew. Oh, why would you do this? Ew. I don't know. This is... Okay. That's normal. I don't know. I don't play with tomato that often, so... Also, that's a good amount of cheese. Oh, yeah. I've got one of those big saws at home. No, this is all... No, it's not a dairy overload. He's gonna eat all this cheese. Don't worry about it. Okay. I assume he's just making, like, a tomato sauce, right? Yep. Yeah, that's all he's doing. Why three bottles? They're taped together. Okay. Okay. He's giving them all little police hats. Is he gonna fill tomatoes with cheese? You making cheese tomatoes? Oh, it's already spilling everywhere. Oh, it's getting messy. Yeah, they had to cut. How is this food? Deep fry this? He's gonna deep fry cheese. Deep frying a block of cheese. Oh, gotta get a salad. This is the only time they've ever put dressing on it. Do not press the tomato button. Don't do it. Ah! Oh, that was visceral. Wow, I hated that. I hated that a lot. I one more time though. It's like those stupid zit popping videos online where they like have a zit the size of two fists and they're like, I'm gonna squeeze
this
it.
This is fucking disgusting.
No, it's okay. No, it was fine. These are the 500 bits. That was really nice. Wow.
Not.
I don't know what to do about this one. This is a lot.
Oi, you! Shut your mouth and look at my watch!
Touch it with his condom thing.
I have been staring in shock at my monitor for this entire sequence.
This was a really bad one. Oh, okay, we're done. Anyways, never push the tomato button. Wow. And his hands. I don't know why his hands. Maybe it's the color grading, but his hands look like dead. This looks like the hands of a corpse pushing against a tomato button. It looks so gross. He's dead inside. There's a lot of purple. They're dirty. One more time, please. One more time. This is for everybody in the back that didn't see it. Like, his hands look fine and red and healthy here.
Ugh.
That puss, it has been bothering me. Thanks.
You're welcome. So glad to have evacuated that for you. Don't make me unfollow. I'm sorry.
Tom, that tomato button is for when you nut too hard.
Yeah, this will take you right out of the mood. I think looks gross. I think it's literally just a block of cheese. I don't know. Chat, feel free to be mad. I think this would taste nasty. I was speechless. This would take way too long to make. It's comically plated. I don't know what fetish that is, but it's a fetish. First bingo. There's gonna be more. Chat is clearly mad. I think it's a dairy nightmare because it's just cheese. I think it would be worse than a frozen pizza. I think that it would be none of these things. I gag.
Who are you? Shut your mouth and look at my wad.
Okay.
When you nut, but they keep pushing the tomato button.
Losing my mind. And we're going to mark off bad editing and unusual ingredients. Because where do you get those tomatoes? Yeah, bad editing for the color grading. You know what? I'm going to unmark unusual ingredients. I think you could get giant blocks of cheese, probably. Maybe not.
Why is Tom drinking cum?
I mean, I'm almost out of cum, too. I'm going to have to go mix some more cum. Once I'm out of cum, we'll go get some more. Don't worry. I'll show you guys my process and how I make it.
Oni-chan, press my tomato button, sugoi.
Oh, this is horrible. This is a bad night. I just wanted to let you all know. It's a bad night. Take a cummy break. Oh, I can't believe he's touching it with his little condom finger. I really don't like that. I don't like the condom finger. That one's stressing me out. Are you deep frying another thing? Are you deep frying cheese again? Oh, and it's like sliced American cheese. It's not even good cheese. He's using a red Solo cup to make cheese circles. Okay. Can you ever use American cheese for anything other than burgers or grilled cheese? Because I don't think there's anything. I don't think there's anything at all. Oh, it's so nasty. It's like the worst. It's like non-cheese. No. Oh, thank you. Cold sandwiches. I don't even put that on cold sandwiches. I can't put a processed American cheddar on cold sandwiches. It's so gross. Egg sammies. Egg sandwiches are good. I can do that. Hot sandwiches are the only time that American cheese is good. Every other time it's bad. Every other time. It's gotta be a hot sandwich. That's it. Whether it's a burger, a breakfast sandwich, a grilled cheese, gotta be a hot sandwich. Yeah, because otherwise it's just not cheese. It's like biting plastic. Cold sandwiches. Dude, I'm not even kidding you. I will make a cold sandwich, and even if I have sliced processed American cheddar, I will not put it on. Is he actually talking? Was he? Do you think he was? I guarantee you he wasn't. I think he's talking to the camera, but we can unmute and listen to the song that they're playing.
Overlap him a little bit so
we get to hear his voice.
We bread from flour first so that your egg wash sticks. Egg, get it all the way in there. Some cheddar with the cup that you're gonna use. Make two rounds on the cheddar.
This is the only time they've ever kept people explaining it.
Cheddar. That way you have the right size. The knife, you take that round off just like that. And we're gonna repeat that process. Make yourself four perfect cheddar rounds. Plastic film, double it up. Place it on top of the cup. Try to center that right. Take your cup out. Take your round. place it on the bottom. You should have that whole piece of cheddar. Turn it just a bit, twist it a bit, fold it, and push that down with the knife.
I'm flabbergasted.
Second piece, put it right there. Try and overlap them a little bit so that they will end up sticking together well. You get yourself a third piece, slide it on in there. Try and make sure it touches the bottom.
That is surreal. I'm not gonna play the audio though. I've made it a point that I don't want to hear their audio. It's amazing. He's talking but not really saying anything. I don't think we're losing anything because he's talking and he's saying things, but he's just saying what we're seeing. So I really don't think we're losing out on anything by not having him talk. They are French. Yeah, his accent is not French. It is. Yeah, it's 80 yard. Okay. I'm going to give him a chance to explain why he's water basting.
Take just a little bit of water and brush the edges to help sticking together. We're going to be putting these in the freezer.
You put water on it to help sticking together?
Get it on in there. Try and make sure it touches the bottom. And take just a little bit of water and brush the edges to help sticking together.
It helps sticking together.
We're going to be putting these in the freezer. And when they are hard enough, we take them back out and then we bread it. Got some olive oil in there, just about a teaspoon. Start with our onions. Give them a little stir. Little garlic, red bell peppers. And we're going to let those cook for about 5 minutes. Once we have our...
It almost feels like a mistake that they kept the VO in, but it's obviously edited around it, so... That's so weird. It's scary, honestly. It's actually nice content. I think it adds a lot. I think it does add a lot. I'm so confused. I don't know why they did it. Because they're keeping in all these segments where he's actually just talking. That's so weird. I feel like they're going off brand. They're finally trying something new. Wow. That is surreal. Now they have to produce real content. Well, I mean, usually what they do is they just like release this as a fucking Instagram video. Like, you can tell by the aspect ratio what they're trying to do. But I'm surprised that they've changed the format. Well, okay. Well, I've already lost track of what's going on. He made a cheese cup and then he made like a chili with no beans. Which chili needs beans, okay? It needs beans. Oh, these look so gross. Oh, they're just frozen American cheese. Oh, there it is. And then he's gonna deep fry the cheese. Ugh. It's cheddar. He sliced it up. Oh, sorry. Was it really cheddar? Oh, fuck. I think he said it was cheddar, but it's... This is a fucking bop. What, did he? He did actually add in beans, I think. Yeah, he actually added beans. It is a chili. Let me start with this. I know he says it's cheddar, but yeah, it's sliced American cheese. That's a sliced American cheese. That's not like cheddar cheese cut into thin strips. That's processed as shit American cheddar. Anyways, no waxy gloss to it. Pure pre-sliced cheddar shit. Maybe you're right. I have trouble distinguishing. You're drunk, probably. You know what? I'll take it. I'll take the L on that one. There's so much breading. They never say what oil. If I'm going to deep fry anything, I feel like I got to use peanut oil. Everyone says that's the best oil to deep fry. Ooh. After the video's done, I want to hear what he says. He's just filling some cheese cups that are deep fried with chili. How do you eat that? Oh. I feel like it's too messy for me, but it doesn't look too bad. I think I would eat it. I think I'd have trouble eating it. I think I'd eat it. Let's see what he says.
Because he's probably got something.
It is important to remember that we let this aside 15 to 20 minutes before serving so that the flavors can mingle a little.
Oh. Why'd they quiet it down for that? He didn't say anything.
So now we're going to try this chili.
What?
Good it is. Mm-hmm. It's on point.
It's on point. Okay, so the editing's really bad. The editing is really bad.
Boy, you! Shut your mouth and look at my wad!
Yeah.
Hey, babe. I love this jam. You want to go out sometime?
Go clubbing.
Where is editing? Is it editing? Was editing bad on here? Bad editing's already marked off.
Damn it!
Do we want to mark off actually good? I see it in chat. I could be convinced. I could be convinced. My issue is that these cups are like hard to eat. Like look at them just like crunching them up. I think it'd be tasty, but I don't know if it'd be good. I'd eat it.
Tom's expressions for these videos is a national treasure.
I'm so happy I was able to invent a video series just so I could make really fucking crazy expressions. Because I have a very expressive face, and I don't use it that often. It's usually just me sitting going, playing Fallout and being very content. Tasty yes, good no. Let's mark it. Let's mark it. Coda, welcome! I'm marking off actually good. I think it's edible. I think we should replace actually good with the edible square. Other than that, it's like, it's kind of nothing. It's just chili. It's just chili in a cheese cup. Which, I know that that's a horrible thing, but like, it's, I don't know. Maybe my standards are going crazy. But man, oh man, this is weird. Weird. Edible, but with an asterisk. Yeah, exactly. Edible, not desirable, I think is what we should shoot for there. Add fries to it. Could we go with fries? Oh, that's a lot of cheese. Is that a mozzarella puff? What is that? Oh, Romano. That's a different cheese entirely. What the fuck? Pepe. Gotta get some pepe. Inferno. Okay, they uploaded the non-English version by accident. A lot of oil, but okay. That is such an oily pasta. Okay. It's just a really weird... I don't think that this would be a tasty pasta, but I think maybe this one's an acquired taste. It looks like vomit. No, it's got little balls. It looks good. Oh, yeah, it doesn't look good. And then bake it again? Why? What are you gonna do to that mozzarella? Wait, is mozzarella hollow in the center? I've never bought mozzarella balls. Oh no, it's just the way he's cutting it. I don't have a torch, I'm sorry to say.
A little mozza hat.
Feta. Is that honey? Dude, I've never had a honey wand. I wish I had a honey wand. They sound great. Lemon zest. Pippi! Olive oil. Jesus. So this is honey and cheese mixture? Sweet honey cheese. Everyone's, what's your favorite Pippi? Feta and honey is classic. Is it? I've never heard of it. Very uncultured.
but feta and honey goo with a ball of mozzarella, and then on top of it is like, was it ricotta? What did they? What was the cheese in this? And Parmesan. It's just cheese. It's just cheese. Pasta dessert. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what to say about this one. Is it too much cheese? Is it not enough cheese? I don't know what's going on. I feel like there's an equal chance that this would be terrible or taste great. It could be either or. I don't know. I like olives. I do like olives. Very French Italian. I'm down to clown. I do think that it's a dairy nightmare, but we already marked that off. This might be a one. It does look pretty good. Damn. I don't think there's anything we can mark off then. Like butter, ranch, excessive chocolate. I don't know. Yeah. I guess it's done. I mean, I guess we could say comical plating, but that's already been marked off too. The first one was just such a riot. Destroyed the bingo card. The last two were like kind of okay. Dangerous torch. I mean, they were okay with the torch, right? Weren't they? Unusual material. I'd mark off unusual material. I don't think the average home chef has a flambe torch. But other than that, I think it's Dunsky-Doo. It's Dunsky-Doo. And with that, I think we should get into the whole crux of this event. I think we should get back into Life Hack Bingo. I think we should procure ourselves some life hacks. And before I do, I'm going to finish off my drink. And I have a question. I have a question. And this is a question about what beverage I should have, because I have no idea. Also, let's get the life hack. Wait, bingo. Let's get the bingo card up. There it is. What should I drink now? I could either have straight whiskey. Oh!
Tom, is Resident Evil 8 good enough to get Windows 10 for?
Ooh! I don't know. Probably not. Do you have a PS4? You can play it on a PS4. You probably thought of that. I don't know. I've never been against getting Windows 10, so. Okay. I'm going to leave that question to chat. Resident 8, good enough to get Windows 10 for? That's an interesting one. What's better? Whiskey, straight whiskey, or strawberry milkies and strawberry soju? Because I will mix the two of them and make that real quick. Or I could just drink straight whiskey. And I will take votes as to what my poison of choice will be.
Come.
Okay, so that's a vote for milkies. Come. Strawberry cummies. Whiskey. I love strawberry. Don't mix alcohol. Fine. Strawberry cum. Okay. We're going to take a cum break. But I hope you come on back in just a second. I am literally going to run to my fridge. What are milkies? Is it literally milk? Milk, and this is going to make you sad. Milkies is refreshing milk yogurt soda. It's carbonated milk. Anyways, think about that for a second. I'll be right back. I'm going to go grab my bottles.
It is me, the boy with too many beverages. Beverage boy.
Urgh. Okay. Thought I hit something back there. Okay, you guys ready? Carbonated milk sounds awful. I'll be honest, it's delicious. Okay. I'm ready.
Let's get some milkies. Hey, let's get some milkies in us.
And Perfect. There we go. Sorry. I don't know what this is going to look like. I mean, it might just look like cum like the last time. Dare you to put milk in a soda stream sometime? I don't own a soda stream. I don't think I ever want to, but that would be fun, wouldn't it? There we are. Hype train.
Don't forget the hot dog with a hole drilled in it.
HD Milkies. Ah. This is broken. Oh, there we go. Lid would not come off. Let me smell it. Ooh. Oh, wow. That smells really good. That smells like a strawberry drink. This smells amazing. Keith, thank you for the 100 bits. It looks like just nothing. It is water. I'm pouring water into a mug. I don't want a soda stream until I get one. Oh, is it that good? I've never had one. Okay, wait. This smells delicious. It's just strawberry flavored soju. Flavored soju is dangerous. Goes down like water too. Well, I'm only having 2 bottles of soju tonight. That's my limit. Oh my god, that tastes like a Kool-Aid drink. That is just like delicious. Anyways, let's fuck it up and put some strawberry milkies inside. Grr. Oh. It's not going to look like cum. It's going to look like blood. Wow. Ah. Look at that. There it is. Strawberry soju milkies. Blood gum. Blum. Blumhouse Films. I mean, though. Thank you, Whiskey, for the 6 months. I got Big Kazoo from me to you. It's a Bloody Mary. Hell yeah. Nothing like a Canadian Caesar. Here we go. Wait.
Oh, you. Shut your mouth and look at my wad.
That's fucking good.
Why are you drinking Placinja?
I don't want any more now. Like blended placenta. Oh, let me try again. This is really fucking tasty. This is actually fucking delicious. Okay, everybody. Okay. I say we mark off our free space and we get to the 5 minute crafts. We get to the crafts. Oh, but before we do, Bacon's got a cursed cat of the day. What's the cursed cat? What's the cursed cat? This is a sad cat. This is a very sad cat.
It's cum, but you tried way too hard.
Yeah, you like forced it and broke something. This is the saddest cat. It's a cat that's being Thanos'd. It's got like a little squishy head. I just want to pat him and tell him it's going to be okay. And we're going to make it through. Oh my god. Oh, carbonated milk would be a bad idea. Ooh, lower pH caused by the formation of carbonic acid. When carbonated water would cause the milk to curdle. Oh yeah, you're right. Oh, ew. Ew. Oh! And likely one of the many reasons that canned lattes and other coffees are nitrogenated instead. Interesting! I didn't know that. Learning stuff. I'm probably gonna forget that, but learning stuff! What a beautiful cat. That's a great cat of the day. I'm gonna make that my background. What's my background right now? My background is a woman about to die. I would rather it be the cat of the day. This is a good cat of the day. There. That did not just happen. Can I, instead of stretch it, can I like center it? Fit? Yeah, there we go. Perfect. That's nice. That's a good cat. I just like seeing it because there's all my icons are covering up its face. It's the Nutella's animal. It's gonna tell you. I don't even know what this would advertise. The cat-like reflexes. Pat the cat. Oh, I want its name to be Pat. Look at that. Oh, drank your cum placenta milkies. Okay. Let's get back to the life hacks, maybe. No more of that. I'm gonna close the cat. I'm gonna get to chat. No more cat. All chat. And let's go to 5 minute crafts, eh? 5 minute crafts. Yeah, that's what I spelled. I mean, it is, but I'm surprised it didn't. Why is it? The I doesn't have a dot. I don't know how I did that. Anyways, let's see what new videos there are. Oh my god, this is 100 greatest hacks. Holy shit. Cold versus warm DIYs. Help us bring the trophy home.
For what? I just want to see what this is. Also, I'm sorry. I'm fucking sorry. I don't know if this is bullying, but something is wrong with that kid. You know when you see a kid in a Tim and Eric sketch and they've like photoshopped the eyes down and the mouth to one side and like all this other stuff to make the kid look kind of weird, like uncanny, but isn't real? That's what that kid looks like. And I know for a fact they photoshopped the shit out of that image, but that child is uncanny. Like, they fucked with the kid's face too much, and the kid doesn't look real anymore. I don't know what's going on with the child. Anyways, before we do anything, what is this? What is help us bring home the trophy? Is this a clip show of all your horrible B-roll? That doesn't look that good. That's not that. Hey, come on now. That's not a good. Nominated for a Webby. Wanna help us bring home the big trophy? Oh my god. So they're going for a Webby. Do you think they'll get it? I kind of don't expect them to. I don't expect them to on the basis that I don't think anyone actively wants to see 5-Minute Crafts. They just kind of gravitate to it because it's numbing nothing. I've been nominated for a Webby for my browsing prowess. Man, I wish I was nominated for a Webby. I don't know what that means. Can you be nominated for a Webby as a person? This is just a streamer? Do they give out Webbies for streamy boys? Ooh, tea. I'll put a nut in some tea. The old tea nut surprise. Okay. Weird. We could watch 26 summer life hacks. Did we do this? Yes, last week. Mystery box challenge. You try to have... What? You have to try with friends. What? We didn't? We didn't do that? Ordinary dog versus TikToker dog? Did they crush its skull? Oh no, it's wearing sunglasses. And it's in a ring light. What is happening? First aid hacks? How long has it been since we did Life Hack Bingo? I don't remember this. I remember the girl versus boy, and I remember the goop toilet. But I don't remember the first aid hacks. Over a month? There's been no way. Did I miss a week of Life Hack Bingo? Oh no. Anyways, let's load up first this one. And also, let's load up top funny pet hacks. It's been 2 weeks. Weird, maybe we skip that one. I don't know. Wait, let's do a little browser. Oh, it's her on the stool. I remember that. Did she just cover her toe in glue? Oh. Oh yeah, and then she puts a pad on her foot. Yeah, I remember this. I think. Oh yeah, the kid doesn't like the stethoscope, so he goes and he's just like, hydrogel. Kid, you're gonna love this shit. And then you just kind of play with it, and you squish it, and boom, now I can hear your heart through your hoodie. Yeah, I remember that. Okay, we're good. We're caught up. We could do summer hacks. I don't remember that being a thing. And, let's do this as well. Okay, let's start up a prediction, and I'm gonna do a prediction with three. Oh, shit. How many submissions closed? Oh, did we finish the last one? Oh, shit. We didn't. What was the last? The last bingo was less than three, right? Or less than... We did. Oh, shit. Hold up. Are we doing another one? Oh, no. Because we got to change the number. We got to go from greater than and less than two to greater than and less than three. This is for the next one. Yeah. Can we reset the prediction? It shouldn't be two. Because it's almost 100% going to be more than two. Thank you. No. If it gets reset, you get your bean back. You don't worry about losing beans. We just got to do up another. Thank you. Sorry about that. That was Chef's Club Bingo. I do less predictions because it is harder to get them, honestly. It's okay, Bacon. That was a new change. That was spur of the moment. There we go. We got the new prediction. How many bingos? Greater than or less than three? And for those who are wondering what the card is, here it is for you. We routinely hit more of these than the Chef's Club bingo, so that's why the rates have to change. But it's still that same threshold of three, you know? It could be more, it could be less. You never know. You never fucking know. And while y'all are voting...
Damn, that's a lot of beans.
I want to take a peek at top funny pet hacks. Are you ready? Are you ready for top funny pet hacks? Why are you doing that to your dog? Why did you do this to your poor dogs? Oh, no. I don't think that you can... He's just going to take the treat that's nearest to him. He wants there too. I don't think that's how to... There is literally not a world where this dog would pick up this treat. I guess if you want to feel really smart, you could beat your dog at not quite tic-tac-toe. Okay, and then there's a cat.
Oh, he's so cute. He's Kiki.
What's he gonna do? Oh, he's giving finger licks. Is this a hack? It says top pet funny hacks. Play a movie of a dog for your dog so that your dog barks at the dogs. Oh. Oh. We're just gonna sniff it out, yeah. Okay. Is this hack piss your fucking dog off? Cool funny hack, bully your dog. Just fuck with your dog, dude. This dog is gonna kill you. I love that she's like, haha, wee, I'm gonna make it look like you're losing all your food. I love that the dog figures it out too. He's like barking and biting his tongue's out at the creature that isn't real. And then as soon as he goes around and under, he starts looking at her like, what were you doing? Why were you doing that to me? Jesus, stop. Why are you doing that? Wow. They're absolutely holding the dog back. Yeah, off screen. Oops. Like over here. Do you think she's pulling on his tail or something? I hate it. This feels like animal abuse in the softest of ways. Train your dog to be violent to other dogs. Yeah. Makes dogs mad square. All right. Well, I think we're set. Are you guys ready? Let's fire into it. I feel like we might have seen this before. Oh, shit. Did we see this one before? We did. We did see this one before. I should have known from the 2 week... Yeah, with the gross ear. Okay. Quick, we're gonna do this one. Wait, was this? No, we saw that one too. Sneak friends into the movies. Wait a minute! Sneak friends into the movies? Be a fat man. That's a lady, actually. Okay, here we go. I love that it's COVID, and they're like, here's a video on how to go to the movies. Get inside me, babe. Hey, babe, get in me. Uh-huh. I have a bad feeling this isn't going to be believable at all. It works. It just works. Have you ever seen it? It works. Shut your mouth. It works. It works, guys. It works. Green light. It works. It works. It creates more problems. That is the stupidest thing. It works. You know what? Yeah, let's mark off fetish. I don't know what fetish yet, but I'm sure it hits some box for somebody. High five. I don't know what... I almost want to mark off bad acting. I'm sorry. What did you just call those gummy worms? I don't think that's marmalade. Hey, sure, dude. So gummy worms in water, and then they get bigger. This video is called How to Sneak Friends into the Movies. I don't... Maybe this is a troll video. I think they forgot about that first title and they made a video about the second title, 25 Viral TikTok Hacks. I think the hack is how to make bigger gummy worms. But they're not... You're not adding anything but water to them. They're just watery gummy worms. I'm gonna just mark off that that's not a hack. And also, that it's gross. That's gross. The marmalade is bigger. Yummy. Okay. What? Why did they do that? It works! They didn't even say it works or it doesn't work. They just... They put a phone in a balloon and then they put it in the water. And it was fine. Because it's in a balloon. And then they cut it. And then they removed the balloon. But the balloon was still wet. So they got the screen really fucking wet. Did she accidentally drop it, or was that on purpose? I can't even tell. That was on purpose. That was on purpose. Her finger just goes away. She's like, whoop, gone. I don't understand. I'm gonna just mark that up. Oh, we already marked off not a hack. Who would do this? Why would you do that? Why would you put... Also, bad acting. Fuck you. Easy. Wait, yeah, waste of a good phone. I don't know what they're doing. Wow. So it's the pulley party, a banana-y hacky. Here we go. She's doing it too for her TikTok. Is that a thing that takes a lot of strength, is pulling apart a banana? I feel like a banana is one of the very few fruits that you could absolutely decimate by doing almost anything to it. And also, it does kind of look fake. Is it the way that it... I don't know. It doesn't look like there's a pre-cut. I don't know. Too clean. It does look too clean. Do you think it's fake? Go get a banana. I don't own a banana. Do you think I'm the kind of guy that owns a banana? I don't know. It does, it feel, the motion of like...
Sandwich and me going to beat your ass.
Thanks. Anyways, the motion looked fake, if you look at it. Where she goes...
Hello, and again, welcome to the Aperture Science Computer Aided Enrichment Center.
Somehow this is all going to tie in together to sneak into the movies, and then you will all see and feel really stupid.
You're right. This is, she's gonna be like, this is how you get two banana halves into the movies. I think, I mean, it's really hard to tell if there's a cut. What I don't like, and what makes me think it's fake, is that she opens her eyes to react to the banana pulling apart before the banana is pulled apart. You see what I mean?
Like, that alone makes me think it's fake. That's the only thing that makes me think it is fake. Because as far as I can tell, it looks like there's no seam. And she does the fake grunty face. And then she reacts here before the banana is open. And boom, now it's open. So, I don't know. I don't know. Also, yeah, this is Busta Groove. I'm going to say it's not possible. I'm